stepping on holy land, unaccounted for. You all have been bombarded with arrows. Or excuse me, darts. Odavin, quick thinking once again, you unfurl the Krig banner as you see these monks step out of the brush. I'm going to need everybody to roll initiative for me, please.
I love having a +7 to initiative now.
Thank God. Ah, damn.
Thank you, Swashbuckler.
Wild.
Nova got a 17.
Yeah. I got a 7.
I will remind you, Nova, I believe you are poisoned from last session.
I am? Okay.
I believe so.
I'll put that on.
Oh yeah, from the darts.
From the darts.
Fucking A. Okay.
Alright. Sigmund and Sybil, what'd you get?
I got a
7.
And Sybil?
18.
Let me roll for Talix. 12. All right, we begin. We do a couple of things. We're going to begin with Odavin. It is your turn.
Ooh, okay.
That aura should be the size of the Krieg rune. I believe it's 20 feet. You can double check for me if I'm wrong.
Everyone within 20 feet of me. Disadvantage on range attacks against them.
Or is it they have disadvantage on attacks against you? On range attacks against you?
It is anyone within the range. I can read it real quick.
Yes, but it's...
Was it?
It's they have disadvantage on ranged against you, or y'all have advantage on ranged against them.
No, so the standard shield, any range attack roll that targets you or an ally of yours has disadvantage if the target is within 20 feet of the unfurled banner.
Okay, perfect.
So basically it's like a warding wind around us.
Perfect. All right, Odavin, you are the first to act.
I will move here. I'll draw one of the short swords and just try to do non-lethal damage. Can you use like the back of the blade or like the hilt?
For sure.
Let's see.
Make your attack, brother.
You attack with the sword. This is weird. 27?
That hits.
And then, I like this remix, by the way.
Yeah, this is sick.
22.
Hits.
Cool. Not too much damage.
Big rolls to start off.
15 points of slashing damage.
Okay.
That is gonna be it. Actually... is it just range attacks? A weapon attack. Okay. That's it.
Cool. You made a melee attack against this one. I need an acrobatics or athletics check from you.
Nat 20.
Nat 20. Perfect. This one is going to move to you, Sybil.
Okay.
Let me pull up there. It's going to make... two attacks against you and then flurry of blows. It can't do this unlimited amount of times though. Flurry of blows, 2 on Chernika. Uh, 14, Sybil.
Does not. Oh, it does hit me actually. Just
nat 20. So 14 and nat 20 on Sybil. On Chernika. 16.
Yep.
And 24.
Both hit.
Okay, so for the first one, Sybil, you're going to take 7 and 15.
Ow, dude.
And Sharnika, you're going to take 15 in total as well.
Sybil, can I do uncanny dodge on that, or is that only for
you? You absolutely can. Uncanny dodge is once per attack. I group the damage together, so I'll give you the higher one, which is 9, half to 4.
Okay.
So 4 plus 6 for 10. So you only take 10. Heal back 5. All right. Sybil, give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
Well,
neither of these are good, but acrobatics, let's see. 9. Oof. Yeah. Sybil, you are thrown back 30 feet. You see, as this monk comes forward, it rushes forward, the bow staff in one hand. It hits with your own staff. This is a melee combatant. You're not really adept with the staff as a weapon. It knocks it down. It bounces on the ground. You're able to catch it, but not before a palm to your solar plexus launches you 30 feet back. You scramble on the ground. That is its turn. Let's see. Sybil, it is your turn.
Okay, let me refresh so I can see where I landed.
Nova, you can give me a perception check while Sybil figures out what she's doing on her turn.
I'm coming. There we go.
What is that? I can't even see it. Oh, that's 6. Sorry.
Okay.
I'll just shoot each of them once with an Eldritch Blast, I think. These three dudes.
Cool. Make your 3 attacks.
Yeah. Plus 13 into each of these.
Oh!
Or 32.
Yes.
30.
Yes.
21? Or 17, sorry.
17. It is going to use its reaction to parry. Well, let me see if it can parry ranged attacks. Yeah, 1 melee or ranged weapon attack. So no, it can't do it.
Right, so the first guy is going to take 9 points of force damage, 2 points of force damage from this, and 6 points of force damage.
All right.
Yeah. A bonus action healing spirit at about 2nd level. Right.
Where are you placing it?
On top of myself, to be honest. Right next to myself, really. Between me and Talix, it's cool. And I'm gonna take that healing die for me. I'll take 3. Not much, but it's something. My turn's over.
Is it a bonus because of the moonsicle?
Yeah, I did roll it.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Nova, it is your turn.
Okay. So, let's see. Sorry, I'm reading what everyone's saying.
You're good. Poisoned is disadvantage on attack rolls and ability checks.
Yeah. Okay. Jeez. Let's do. What is the rainbow?
You're supposed to be doing your paper.
Okay, so I'm gonna. Sorry, I had a thing in mind and then something changed.
You're good, shit happens, you're good.
30 feet, 20 feet. So I can make. I'm gonna do Hunger of Hadar. Yeah. I'm gonna back it up just a little bit. What's this orb we're in?
That's the aura of the banner that Odavin has. If you're in it, then ranged attacks have disadvantage on you.
Okay, I'm gonna go on the edge here then, and then I'm gonna
smart.
Make a 20-foot circle, and then I'll move it. Hang on, 20-foot. Okay, I can get these guys. So they
perfect.
All have. Let me just put it in the chat. Oh, it rolled the damage too. Okay, cool.
That's fine.
But
it's a deck save.
Yeah, it's gonna be a deck save DC 17.
All right,
and
let's
then...
see.
attacking creature starts its turn, the area will take 2d6 cold damage.
Oh, the first one gets a 23. Second one just rolled a nat 18. And then, they rolled, both of them rolled really high. 15 and 18 plus their modifier for 23 and 20. It's not too crazy for a monk. Plus 5 for a monk isn't crazy.
Yeah, no, I should have known.
No, it's good. Now you know. They take half damage, or?
When they start their turn in the area, they'll take 2d6 cold damage, but if they end their turn in the area, they have to succeed on that dex save throw or take the 2d6 acid. So once they start their turn, they'll take 2d6 cold. You want me to just roll that now, or?
Oh, so it's any creature that starts its turn takes 2d6 cold damage. Any creature that ends its turn must make a dex save or take the acid damage.
Sorry, I didn't.
So they don't take any damage up front. It's when they end their turn, they make a dex save. When they start, it's just free 2d6.
Yep.
So when they start their turn, they'll take the damage because they haven't started their turn yet.
All right, yeah, that'll probably be my bonus action. Forgot about bonus action.
Before you do your bonus action, because this may change things, this one held its action when someone got within 5 feet of it. It was going to take a swing. This one right here.
Oh shit!
That was the hidden one. It was he was hidden. That's what the perception check was for earlier. 16 to hit?
No, that doesn't hit.
Misses anyway. All right.
Perfect opportunity because I'm gonna bonus action just shove him. That's it. I don't know if I make a check for that. It's Shieldmaster.
Baldur's Gate. Oh, Shieldmaster. Perfect. Read the Shieldmaster. It is Baldur's Gate.
It just shoves them 5 feet away. It doesn't.
Oh,
say
cool.
They
so it's your opposed athletics against their acrobatics, just a regular shove.
Oh God, so this is gonna be rough. That's a 4.
They are proficient. 10 plus 7, 17.
Oh well, that's my turn.
No problemo. Let's see. This one starts its turn, so roll 2d6 cold damage.
Okay. Ew.
For how much? 5?
Yeah, just 5.
Damn! Not bad on 2d6, dude. There, it's gonna get right in the middle. It's gonna make 2 attacks on Odavin, and then a flurry of blows. Actually, 1 attack on Sigmund, 1 attack on Odavin, 1 flurry of blows on each of them, because I have to do it specifically for a reason.
I mean, you don't have to, though.
Do. 24 on Odavin, 18 on Sigmund.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, let's see. And then 15 on Odavin. And 10 on Sigmund.
Sorry, I made a fucking
cool. 10 does not hit.
Cool, so 1 hits for both of you, but it's the attack that hits. So I need... Oh, boy.
I wish I didn't waste this.
8 on Odavin. And 7 on Sigmund. I need... Sigmund, give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
Ah, crap. I'll do acrobatics. Oh.
6.
Am I grappled?
You are pushed 30 feet away.
30 feet?
30 feet. Same. It just happened to Sigmund like 30 seconds ago.
What?
What? That's its turn, though. This one... I'm going to come here.
Oh, please stop.
I'm jumping them.
They are jumping them. 4 attacks on Sigmund, 2 regular attacks, 2 flurry of blows.
Ew.
21, 15.
Yeah.
21.
Yeah.
And 17.
Yep. 13 AC.
God damn, Sigmund. 31 points of damage on all of those attacks. You good? You up?
Yeah.
Cool. Give me another acrobatics or athletics check.
No!
Yeah, it's rough. These guys are annoying. These guys are annoying because they're just pushing you away. They're just airbending you away, dude. It's rough.
What fucking gym is this? What Pokemon gym is this?
I don't think it's a Pokemon gym. I think it's...
No, the fucking...
It's not...
Just the movie.
Oh, honestly... Sigmund, another 30 feet back. It's Talix's turn. Y'all tell me, what is Talix doing?
Fucking non-lethal raging. Swings, if possible.
No. Oh. Rage.
Cool. He's gonna rage swing on this person twice.
Non-lethally.
Non-lethally. It's actually barbarian. Oh, nat 19. Hell yeah.
Down the blade of wood.
And 23, both hit.
Oh, should I have made a con save for the poison at all?
At the end of your turn, yes, I'm so sorry.
No, you're
absolutely
fine,
right.
You're fine.
Yeah, let me resolve Talix's damage first.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. 6.
12. Oh my god.
Or 4, sorry.
12 and 14. Yeah, that'll get this dude out of here. You see Talix with the blunt edge of his sword knocks the dude out. He crumples like a bag of potatoes, falls to the ground, hunched over. Where's he going to move, if anywhere?
He'll move
attacks,
down towards,
that's a bonus action.
I think down towards me, probably.
Cool. I'm just going to move here. It is this one's turn. That Hunger of Hadar is annoying. Do they just have to end or start their turn in it? That is brutal. Brutal. Sigrid.
No! Leave him alone.
Just two dart attacks.
Why? Against me?
Yep.
Why?
24.
That's the chainsaw, man.
And 23.
Yeah.
I don't know why there's lyrics to this. I don't know why there are lyrics to this. There shouldn't be. Ruin my vibe. Ruin my vibe. 23 and 24? Yeah.
Can they do more than 4 damage?
Do you have 4 hit points?
Yes.
Oh my god. Yes, Sigrid, you're going down, bro.
Cool.
You are stable, though. They are not, you can tell, and I'll say this to everybody, biddingly, they are not trying to murder you all. You see Sigmund fall, the dart hits him in a perfectly shot place right underneath the right in the underarm. As his body seizes up, hitting that pressure point, your body stiffens, Sigmund.
Yeah.
Your eyes get hazy and you...
Good
night.
All right, let me actually get my actual playlist. It was fun at first.
Does he make like a me saving throw? Huh? Does Sigmund get to make a me saving throw? Yeah.
Sigmund is stable, so he's not making death saves. He is stable unless someone heals him.
Okay.
Alright. Cool.
So he's not dying, which is
I'm
good. He
dying.
Just doesn't have a turn unless someone heals him.
Okay.
That's that one's turn, though. It would be Sigmund's turn. He's unconscious. Chernika, it is your turn.
Yellow. It is my turn. I am going to attack the one that is right below me. I'm gonna try and hit him twice. This is a try because my dex is really bad right now. I got a dirty 20.
Hits.
Huzzah! And another dirty 20.
Hits! Good shit.
Suspended. Does roll damage for me in here? Oh, it doesn't. This is so sad. Okay. Sorry. Okay, rolling damage right now. That is gonna be 7.
Alright.
And 6. And then I'm going to...
How do you do this?
Oh my gosh. Also, it's non-lethal. It's non-lethal.
For sure. For sure. How do you do
just
this?
Just takes, the bottom of her sword and just, like, bonks him twice on the head.
The first one, he tries to bring it up. You go for a quick hook. It hits the stomach. The guard drops, knocks him in the head, falls to the ground unconscious. Anything else, Chernika?
Bonus action, disengage.
Smart.
Gonna skadoodle over here. Sybil, can I get that sweet, sweet healing, please?
Yeah. That's sweet, sweet healing.
What do I roll? What do you roll?
There you go, you got 4.
Oh, thank you. It's my turn.
Cool.
This one... 30 dash, still can't get to Sigmund. But you all see this one booking it towards Sigmund.
Why?
This one right here.
Why? What? He's already down! Kicking a man while he's down.
They're gonna take him. That's what they're gonna do. They're gonna grab him and run.
I'm gonna... Yeah, no.
Finally, someone wants me.
Whoa. Not the married woman, undoubtedly.
Oh, those things, you did that for the wedding.
Whoa.
Right. I need a perception check from Nova. In the heat of battle, in the heat of combat, is where your position.
Fuck!
Great.
I'm trying.
You are trying.
I've never been good at perception. Like, it's only a negative one, but I always roll so bad.
this one does come out of hiding. He got to use his action to dash to get there. They don't have Step of the Wind. But he is going to get right here by Sigmund.
Please let it be my turn.
Yes.
Nova, you can give me another perception check.
Okay!
Because just of where you're positioned, good spot where you're positioned. Oh my god, you can't make it out. Oh, David, it's your turn.
Cool.
God, girl.
I wish I had inspiration.
Perception check.
Yeah. I feel like it's important.
Your turn, Odavin.
Cool. I'm going to Misty Step as a bonus action here. And then I'm going to move 30 feet to interpose myself. And I will take two swings at this one. The one on the other side of Sigmund.
Okay. You see, as Odavin, you teleport there, you're rushing, you see this one leaning down to try to get Sigmund's arm. As soon as you arrive, he drops him and gets into a fighting stance.
Wait a minute. That's
back
weird.
Up. I'm just gonna fucking swing at him twice. Nineteen
hits.
Cool. And then 22.
Hits.
Thirteen
damage. All right. Anything else?
Yes, I'm actually gonna Action Surge. It take two cool. strikes on this one as well.
Okay. I am gonna use the reaction.
Okay. Yeah.
You'll still get your Action Surge, but I am gonna use the reaction. Give me an Acrobatics or Athletics check.
No, another nat 20.
Perfect. All right, Axe Surge, make your other two attacks.
Where are those for my attack rolls?
Honestly, dude.
Not plus 100, dude.
Could you imagine?
17?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then...
No, first. 17. This one's going to use his reaction to parry, so it doesn't hit. 13, second one misses, yeah. Off base.
Yeah. That is, that's it for me.
All right. Let's see.
Whoops.
Oof, whoops. This one starts in the Hunger of Hadar, so Nova, give me the 2d6 cold. Oh my god.
I know. I'm not rolling great today, but
it happens.
Yeah.
This one is gonna go here. Can it go 20? Yes, it certainly can. Same thing as Odavin and Sigmund. One attack on each of you and then one flurry of blows on each of you, Chernika and Sybil.
This is so rude.
But I'm down!
Chernika and Sybil.
Oh, okay.
25 to Sybil. 14 to Chernika.
It needs
to attack misses. Oh, okay, it hits. 17 to Sybil, and then 9 on Chernika. So, 2 hit on Sybil, and 1 hits on Chernika.
Let's go.
Sigmund ass AC, girl.
2 on Sybil.
Sodded.
15 to you, Sybil.
Yeah, I got it.
And 7 to you, Chernika.
Okay.
Chernika, give me a acrobatics or athletics check.
I would love to. I will do acrobatics. I got a natural 1 for 8.
Okay!
It's fitting with my dex being an 8 right now.
This is so brutal, the fact that how they're positioned. You're pushed back 30 feet. As Chernika, you're flying through the sakura trees. One catches you with a bow staff attempt to your back.
Oh my god.
We are just getting juggled.
14?
Eats a feet.
It's like Alan versus the Viltrumites when one punches him. He falls, just gets caught by the other. Nine more
not
points
like
of damage
this.
To you, Chernika.
Not like that.
You know, I'm gonna use my uncanny dodge to have that to 4.
Cool, absolutely. This one. Nova, give me another perception check. Actually, Chernika as well.
Perception? Oh, let's fucking
perception
go.
From both of you.
Bro.
Guys!
Give me advantage!
Get him out now. Get him out now. Get him out now.
Yeah, get him out now.
God. This
He's
one is going
to
make
me to notice this shit.
Two the same thing. One attack on each, and then one flurry of blows on each.
Okay.
So, one on Nova.
Fucking rats are there. Damn.
22 to hit Nova.
Yep.
Odavin, we're ready to be a
clone. 11 to hit Talix, doesn't hit.
Damn. And then the flurry of blows. Talix can take it, too.
Yeah. 21 to hit Nova.
Yeah!
And 18 to hit Talix, which will hit. So okay. 2 on Nova, this will be.
Healing Spirit. We're good. Alright.
16 points of damage to you, Nova.
Okay.
And Talix, this is halved for 9, half to 4. Yeah, he's good. Talix at 99. But Nova, give me an athletics or an acrobatics check. And again, this is at disadvantage because you're poisoned.
Fuck, okay.
These motherfuckers got combos.
3.
Almost like they're monks.
Or something like that.
Pushed 5. Back 30 feet.
Oh, fuck. Okay. I know what I need to do now.
I know what I must do.
I know what I must do.
Well, it's your turn.
That just decided it for me.
Alright. Hit me for this probably, but alright. I will cast my Master of Wounds on the 4 of us if I can hit us all from over here. I don't know. We'll see. You're getting kind of bodied, yo. Oh, 30 feet? Yeah, I'm way good. This shit's huge. I can get a
damn
problem. Including me.
So yeah, everyone except Odavin and Sigmund.
I'll be there soon, boys. Just hang on.
Thanks.
25 to all of us.
Let's go.
Big!
Big heals.
That's crazy.
Bonus action. All right, I'm gonna have to leave these ones to y'all. 30 feet this way. Movement speed 34 feet. My healing spirit's gone. I'm out of range. Boing. Cool. Gert comes flying back. Yeah. Love it. That's it for me.
All right. Let's see. So anyone within range? I think now Chernika is within range. You see this one standing on the water, takes out, just coming out of cover as it darts out of the brush. It takes this dart, like, blowpipe as it shoots it at you, Chernika, twice. They're rats. They're monks, dude. They're like ninja monks.
We never do good against monks. Never.
This group does not do good against monks. No, this Discord does not do good against monks. Okay, so...
No, when I'm the monk, it fucking sucks.
It's humble.
14 points of poison damage. Give me a con save, Trinica.
I would love to. Oh, I really hate having an 8 in everything. Ooh, 21.
Succeeds! You're not poisoned!
Let's fucking go!
Nova, it is your turn.
So, I need to get the fuck over to Sigmund. I have a feeling. I feel like I should. So I'm going to bonus action, cunning action, dash, 60 feet. Trying to avoid their
movement and bonus action. Yep.
And then I'm going to action dash. Is that possible?
It absolutely is for 90 feet.
Just to get over to this area.
That's 40 feet. You got 40 feet of movement?
For a dash, yeah.
A dash is just your movement, girl. A dash is just your movement.
Is it not double my movement?
No. So that's the common misconception. The way a dash works is you just move up to your movement. When you move and dash, that's double your movement. If you have 30 feet, you can move, and then you action dash for 30, right?
Okay.
What you're saying is you move 30, action dash for 60. That's not how dash works. You
okay,
see what I'm
so
saying?
It would be like 90 in total, right?
So 90 in total. So you moved 60, that's your movement and your bonus action dash, and then your action dash is just your movement again.
Fuck.
You know someone what? Can check me if I'm wrong.
No,
that's
no,
how
you're,
I've been running it this whole time.
That sounds right. I'm just going to Dimension Door there. Like, I'm going to Dimension Door right behind Sigmund.
Fucking huge.
That's my last... Huge. That's my last spell slot, but I think it'll be okay. And with that being my action, God, what do I got for bonus actions? Anything? I guess... I'll just do something more thematic, I suppose, but just kind of take my shield and shield it over Sigmund, and I'll be like, just ready, I guess. There's nothing I can do for my bonus action, I suppose, but...
For sure. It's
can
so,
I make another
see,
perception?
there's no one around. You're making a perception check to see, like, if the hidden ones that are moving. That's what
oh,
you were making
gotcha,
perception
gotcha,
checks
gotcha,
for.
Gotcha,
yeah,
gotcha,
yeah,
gotcha.
Yeah. It's nothing else other than the hidden ones that are moving upwards within a certain radius. Even that is so worded weird. With a speed of 30 feet, for example, you can move up to 60 feet on your turn if you dash. Just say that's you can move great. Another yeah. equal amount to your feet. It's just so...
That's what it's worth.
So worded, yeah.
Right. But yeah, I just one. Dimension Door there and try to shield Sigmund.
This one again is going to... This one comes out of the shrubbery and makes two... let me... Not from, yes, perfect. Two shots against Chernika.
Let's go.
Simba got jumped. Now Chernika's getting jumped.
21.
Ouchie.
And 23, right?
Yep. Double ouchie.
11 points of poison damage. Give me a con save.
I would love to, Adrian. I got a 17.
17 succeeds, Chernika. Yeah, damn.
Good job.
This one is going to move 30. Mm-hmm. Two attacks on Nova to try to get her out of there. Might flurry blows if these don't hit. 16?
No.
12?
No.
Damn, both hit flurry of blows twice on you. It can't push you away because that's hit with an action. 21.
Yeah, that'll hit.
Okay.
No.
And 12. God, okay, only one hits. Hell yeah.
Alright.
For max damage, 10 points of damage.
Okay.
It's Talix's turn. Oh, it's okay. Talix is gonna swing twice on this guy. He's raging. 21 will hit. 27 will hit. 12 and 14. That guy's out of here. Taz can move. Which way is he moving? Towards Chernika or towards the rest of the group?
It's Chernika. Chernika needs support.
Cool. Thank you. Go right here. This one.
Leave Chernika alone. Oh. Sorry, Xavier.
See. Can't look at the range. This one. Yeah, this one can pick up Sigmund. Nova and Odavin, you do get opportunity attacks. He can get there with some of his movement left. He's going to pick up Sigmund and try to dip out. He doesn't have all his movement. He has 30 feet. You can make an opportunity attack.
Yeah, absolutely I will be. Let's see. 20 to hit?
20 will hit.
Oh, I think it added sneak attack by accident. So take,
fucking no, 13.
Minus 5, so it's 9.
13 doesn't hit. 9 points of damage. Right? They're gonna go this way.
Oh, god damn
Bye,
it.
Bye, guys!
Why are you taking our doctor?
Hopefully he's not the only one.
Bill Cosby, please stop.
Another two attacks from this one to Chernika.
No means no, Bill Cosby.
No.
10?
No!
And 24.
Yes!
Yeah!
Yeah.
7 points of poison. Give me a con save, please.
Ouchie, ouchie. A 16?
Succeeds, dude. What the fuck? Nika's just lit up with darts, like in Minecraft when you're covered in arrows, and you're just like, "Hey, what's up? What's up?
Yeah, you doing?"
Yeah, it would be Sigma's turn. He's unconscious. Still hasn't received any healing. Chernika, it's your turn.
She is very battered and not looking too hot. Not gonna lie. Nevertheless, I'm gonna try hit them twice.
Oh, we'll make you two attacks.
You know, she always looks up. But right now, she's like covered in poison.
And blood.
She got an 8.
I'm so sorry, girly, no.
Really?
An 8-13?
I'm so sorry, girly, no. Oh, no.
Yeah, because her fucking dex is 8. Fuck.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, girly.
You know what? No, this is fine because I'm going to take a. Hunting action to disengage.
Yeah.
Yes, bitch.
30. And then I have this like cool thing called my field being a cat. Well, I don't know. Well,
I'll drop the circle, by the way.
No, I'm good here right now. Okay. I'm just scared. Can I do anything else? I use my bonus action. Yep, okay.
Cool. This one right here. 4 attacks on Odavin. Hopefully the first 2 hit, because those are the ones he wants to push him away. 19?
19.
And that 20.
Cool. I will reaction.
Alright, use your reaction to opportunity attack.
Sorry,
so the first one is going to be 7. This is all bludgeoning, by the way. I didn't feel the need to clarify that, but it is bludgeoning. 7 and then 16.
Ooh.
Give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
It'll be okay. Can I? Hold on.
I'm getting strange for some change. We can get strange for some change.
Yeah.
Question.
Answer.
With quick draw, it says that I can stow a firearm and then draw another firearm as a single object interaction. If I'm holding, because I assume I'm holding the banner, which is why I'm using one sword.
Mm-hmm.
On my turn, could I drop the sword and draw the pistol, the smaller weapon?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Sure.
Can I willingly fail the acrobatic check and just get pushed?
You can.
Yeah.
You absolutely can. Cool, so you're pushed 30 feet. You come up with this plan very quickly. The monk doesn't pick up on it, not really intuiting that. You brace for it, it hits you, you feel like the bone in your forearm just bend slightly as this fist hits you. The stance is rock solid. You're flown, your legs are swept under you as you're flown back. All right. And then this one, does he have any movement? Let me go back to his turn. I already reset, fuck it. Okay. This one. This one comes out and shoots two darts at Talix. Oof. 24 and 20. These are poisoning, so Talix isn't going to be resistant to these.
13 points. Oh, I forgot to make my con save. Let me do that.
Please, I keep forgetting to ask. I'm sorry. I need a con save from Talix. 17? He has plus 60. 17 succeeds. You're no longer poisoned. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
15 just succeeds. He's not poisoned. He is out. This one. Can he target Chernika through this? Yes, she is within range.
AJ, I have a question. Since there's a tree in the way, do I get cover from, like, partial cover?
If you were, like, by the tree, I would make that argument. You're, like, in the opening. Essentially, he's shooting, like, from the side of the tree underneath the... It's top down, so he's, like, shooting from the, like, by the bark through you.
I tried.
If you were by it, I'd absolutely make that argument, but you're kind of in the open at the moment. Yay, Karina!
Finally!
Karina.
Nine to hit.
It doesn't hit.
And 19.
That really hits.
I'm sorry. 7 points of poison damage.
Owie.
Give me a con save, please.
I would love to, AJ.
Need a 15.
I can give
you my god, guys! What is happening on these con saves?
I know.
I think Trinita, like, canonically, she's just done so many drugs that she's built a tolerance to poison.
Another two darts coming at you.
Another two tolerance points.
Another two tolerance points. God, another nat 18. And nat 1. So one hits.
Oh, thank god.
That's crazy.
For 8 points of poison.
Oh, boy.
Give me a con save.
You know, I'm going to use my uncanny dodge to make that 4.
Smart. Okay.
Yeah, and then con. Come on. Oh, thank god. 21.
God damn it, dude. What is happening?
Let's go.
Whoa.
Odavin, give me a perception check.
I'm like that, though. But I'm him, though.
Okay! You see this one break out of the shrubbery. You hear the movement as your head whips after you get on your feet again as this monk is just darting towards you.
Hey, back up, Leia.
Back up, Leia!
Talix, are you in the forge?
Yeah, I am.
Alright.
We've been using your character.
Yes. This one is going to make 2 attacks against you. You are raging currently. Nat 1 misses. Nat 18 for 25, and then 2 flurry of blows. 21. And 24. So 3 hit.
Are they humans? Attacking me?
They are. We're different, like, different humanoid species, yeah. Yes. 21 points of bludgeoning, half to 10. They are not going to attempt to push you. Kind of like where you're at. This one will make another four attacks on you, Talix. This other one, 25, 14, 25, and 17.
The two last hits,
14. All right. 27 points of bludgeoning, half to 13.
Oh.
This one comes out of the shrubbery.
Disadvantage on anyone else.
One more time.
They had disadvantage on hitting anyone else but me.
Oh, these two. Okay. No. This one is going to make another two dart attacks on you, Chernika.
Let's go.
We're not looking so bad.
I will also say, Talix, they're not trying to kill. Like, Sigmund is unconscious. He's not rolling death saves. He's stable. 24 and 19.
And we're not trying to kill them.
Angie, I have 8 hit points.
Have we gotten a single one of these guys down?
I'm gonna reduce them.
Yes,
by
you got
6.
Like 3.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna reduce them.
He's 20 feet away, girl. This 30, one over here.
30. It's my range.
This one is 50 feet away from you, actually. When you measure it, this one over here, 50 feet away.
I thought he was.
How
AJ?
Yeah. Huh? So 5 and 5.
I'm down.
Chernika's down. Okay. Similarly to Sigmund, Chernika, you don't make the con save. You're unconscious. The poison isn't lethal poison. As you're hit with this dart, one hits you in your knee, right in the perfect spot where the cartilage and the joint meets. Your leg locks up. You start falling to the ground as the other one gets you in the neck, and you drift off into a sleep.
Oh,
thank
no.
Honk. This one. This one is going to make two attacks on you, Nova.
Fucking bring it.
Try to push you away. 12. Not 19 for 26.
That's good. I need
one of them to hit. Give me a acrobatics or athletics check.
Acrobatics it is.
Yeah. 7 points of bludgeoning damage.
I think 16, right?
16 does succeed.
Okay.
So you are not pushed, but that means two more attacks are coming your way.
Okay.
22. Yeah, one more time. Yeah. 25. All right, thank you very much. What? 13 points of bludgeoning.
Okay.
This one...
There's so many on the turn tracker. Oh my
There's
god.
So fucking many of them.
Oh my god. I don't know,
this
man.
This one's gonna go right here. Go to Chernika, and you also see this one comes over to Chernika, leans down, tries to put one arm over his shoulder. On his next turn, he's gonna try to get her, and try to dip out. Actually, Odavin, it's your turn.
Fucking A! Hey gang, we're losing. It's crazy. I'm gonna fucking quick draw the Drake Bane. Like, sorry. I'm gonna take a shot at this one.
Okay.
I'm gonna expend a grip point to make this a winning shot.
Okay! Smart!
So plus 11.
Did I get skipped? A bunch of people got out of it.
Your turn is a misses, brother. And that's a misfire.
Yep.
You pull out the gun. Your forearm's still shaking. You still afflicted by Spirit Rod. The symptoms abated. It starts coming back slightly. Your forearm shakes. The shot goes wide. As Sigmund is over this guy's shoulder to fireman, he's not hunched over, not using strength. He's lifting Sigmund with kind of using like physics and distributing his weight evenly so he can pick it. He hears the gunshot goes off, one foot goes up as it pings on the stonework, and goes wrong as the gun cracks in your hand. Anything else, Odavin?
I don't get my second attack. So I'm just gonna move, I guess. Yeah, I'm gonna do...
How are you gonna make your second attack?
I thought I don't get my second attack.
Oh. Because I was like, that would be cool if you did. Because I thought the misfire, yeah.
It's a fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Fucking interrupt on my turn. No, that's it.
Can you repair it as an attack, as though? An action. As an action. Not yet, huh? Yeah, later you can, 15. As a bonus action. Fuck, that's brutal, dude. This is rough, because he's right here. That's 15 feet of movement. He's going to take Chernika.
Look
and out. He's going to book.
Damn it.
That's the difficulty friend. With them. They're just trying to knock y'all out of way to get them. I need a... I'll just give this to you, actually. It's not really a check. The two people they're carrying are also two people that have been afflicted with spirit rot. Keep that in mind.
That's weird.
This one... Yeah, this one is over here. Is going to help support. He's going to move. And actually, he's just going to hold his action to make a dart attack if anyone comes within 5 feet of Chernika. This one... two attacks on Talix. Hopefully try to get the push.
There's so many of them down there. Oh, there's like
20
seven of them out there.
And 11. Talix, you're gonna take 7 points,
no,
half to 3.
Wait, there was 11 that to hit?
20 and 11 to hit.
Okay, the 20 hit.
Yeah. You're going to take 3 points of bludgeoning. Give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
I'm raging if I do athletics.
Mm-hmm.
Advantage, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, we had you rage. Natural
24, 31. Fuck yeah. You're not pushed. 2 more flurry of blows coming at you. Oof. 13. And 11. Okay, both those miss. Sybil, it is now your turn.
Kind of reaction, look at this monk standing in front of me. Can you cure him? Just in common, I don't know if he can respond to me.
The head turns, doesn't really say anything. He's a man on a mission. He's moving. But like, he acknowledges the question. Like, it's not like he just fell on deaf ears. It's like,
okay,
he turns so
he
to you and
just...
He could
understand me. He just
could understand you. He just chose not to. Exactly.
So how does magic work when, in terms of non-lethal? Am I off the table? Can I cantrip my way onto it somehow?
I always say, like, a cantrip can be non-lethal, right? Like, I'll give a cantrip as non-lethal. A first-level spell,
yeah,
or anything above, that's hard, because that's a resource that you're expending. You only have a finite amount of first-level spells. You can do a cantrip all day long.
Yeah.
It's kind of the thing, at least in my games, with like a melee versus a caster. You can't be a wizard and be like, I firebolt you and yeah, do it non-lethally. Take this mote of flame to your face. Non-lethally, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah. All right.
Non-lethally, exactly, you know?
I'm going to...
Meteor Swarm. Non-lethally. Can't for sure.
I'm going to Eldritch Blast. Non-lethally.
Non-lethally.
Two on the one that has Chernika, one on the one that has Sigmund. Plus 13.
Okay. Do you have the range? Yes, you do.
Yeah. Okay. Damn. Chernika. Damn, that's not good. 27, and then
hits.
Sigmund. Please, Sigmund. 25, it looks like.
Hits. Yeah.
Okay, so for Chernika, this guy's going to take 1 point of non-lethal force damage. Sigmund's taking 8, no non-lethal.
Okay. He's still up.
No! Bonus action, healing word, Chernika.
Okay.
Because I have a feeling Chernika might actually go over the grab. I don't think.
He does have a negative dollar physical stats, but we'll see. Better than nothing.
Alright.
Thank you, Sybil.
Anything else, Sybil?
I'm literally blocking this guy's path on purpose.
Cool.
Causing problems on purpose.
Gonna come here. Yeah, I'm sorry, Trinity, because they see you get healed. 2 more attacks coming to you from this one. 2 darts.
It's a could she argue for the guy being a shield?
I will say it's at disadvantage because you are considered prone, yes. 19 and 24 to hit on the first one.
Those are at disadvantage?
Yes, so 19 and 24, so 19.
Yeah, those both hit.
And yep. Second attack. Oh my god, a nat 20 and a 10. So we'll take one.
She's down.
So one hits, a 19. Okay, okay. 7 points of poison.
Let's go! She's still up. No, you have 8.
Oh.
So you have 1 hit point left. Okay.
No way!
Nova, it is your turn.
Okay, so I'm going to do some Eldritch Blast, but I want to take them bit by bit. So I first want to see if this will, like, the first one's going to hit, but I'm going to get the guy with Sigmund and do Grasp of Kadar to pull him back if it hit.
Okay.
So let me roll to hit for Eldritch Blast number 1. Natural 20.
Woo!
And I pull him back 10 feet towards me, and I'll be like,
so roll damage
first. Taking him.
Roll damage first, because you might take him out.
I could.
Could.
Well, that's pretty good.
Non-lethally.
Yeah, you guys watch Nova. This one is booking it. You take it. This guy gets Eldritch Blast on both sides. From Sybil holding Sigmund, he turns around. His back hits the damage. He turns around again as your Eldritch Blast hits him in the side. He drops Sigmund as he goes writhing in pain on the ground. That guy's out of there.
Now, is it possible in the middle of my Eldritch Blast to bonus action disengage and move?
That's going to be tough because Eldritch Blast is one whole thing. It's not an attack.
That's okay.
Eldritch Blast is
wondering.
One spell, for sure.
Then
so I'm going
to
say
I'll do my
you have
next
to,
two Eldritch Blasts on the one near
Oh,
Trinica.
I'm so sorry. You're within 5 feet of another enemy. Roll that at disadvantage. A ranged attack within 5 feet of an enemy is disadvantage.
Yep.
I thought it was the target that...
Nope. If someone's within... y'all get me on this rule every single time because I think the same thing... But the way it works is if you're
swiping hands away.
That's
the best way. Volt and Ryan both going like, yeah.
All right, let's see.
Maybe not 20. You could still hit. I just got to make sure.
Okay, that's a natural 13 plus whatever 22.
Hits.
So yeah,
it's good. Still good.
Still
cool.
Hit. Okay,
but
and then
just
my
for
next
future. Yep.
My next two Eldritch Blasts are going to be on the one on Trinica.
Okay, they
and
both
I will
are at disadvantage as well.
Yeah. Yep. There's two of them. So let's see. So the first one. That's a natural 3. And then the second one, that's a natural 6. Let's see if either of those hit, though, with my modifier.
12 and 15. 15 does hit.
Okay, and can I grasp with Dar on him, too, just to get him 10 feet back towards me?
You can.
Okay, and then I'll roll the damage for him.
Yeah.
And that's 9.
9
force
all
damage.
Right.
Does that do him in at all?
He's still up. Still
okay,
holding.
And then bonus action disengage and get the fuck out of here. Try to get to Sigmund. Yeah, disengage, bonus action. I'm going to be right next to Sigmund. If anyone tries this again, I swear to God. but that's my turn.
Not
initially
counts. Cool. This one. I'm going to come here. First, let's see. 16. Yes, perfect. Gonna make a dart on Chernika. It is at disadvantage.
Let's go.
11.
It doesn't hit.
And then the second one at disadvantage. 13.
It doesn't hit.
Both miss. Hell yeah. This one is going to come right here. Actually, right here. Let me get my movement because I need my movement correct for this. Two attacks on Nova.
Okay. Wish I could shield, but oh well.
Oof, 9.
Oh, might not need to.
And 24.
That one does hit, yeah.
I need a acrobatics or athletics check as you take 8 bludgeoning.
You got this.
Acrobatics. Let's go.
8. You are pushed 30 feet.
Oh my lord.
And this one is going to come right here by Sigmund and attempt the same thing. Talix, it is your turn. Oh, excuse me. At initiative count, I should have done this before that one's turn. At initiative count 15, Chernika's up, Nova's up, Sybil is just outside the line, and Talix. I need Nova, Chernika, and Talix to give me a perception check, please.
I would love to.
Okay, that might be okay. Let's see. 13?
Okay.
18?
Okay. Yeah. All of you get it. You see stepping from the road is a single individual. They're dressed in this colorful haori and a hakama, this traditional East Asian style wear. There's a massive katana to her side. Her hair is black and it's tied up in a ponytail. And she's just slowly walking, holding the katana in its scabbard with the, I can't remember the name, the Nagaraki wrap that ties it around the belt. And she's just slowly walking.
Oh no, that's a bad sign. That's a, you don't want anyone slowly walking towards you.
Can you ping her?
Yes.
She's on the right side of the map, the very
edge.
She's
rolling initiative for her. Let me hide her real quick so y'all see her name. Private GMO. What'd she get? Very low. Wow, she got a nat 1.
A skill issue.
I mean, even with her modifier, but she's still gonna go. Nah, it's not that. It's not that high. It's not fucking crazy. It's crazy, not that crazy. Let me hide her. This one.
Be right back.
And I believe all of them. That's its turn. She is going to move 60 feet. And then she's going to dash, but not all of her 60. She's just going to dash 35 to stand at these crossroads.
Oof.
This one, I'm just going to unhide them. They're kind of done trying to be sneaky. This one's going to come here. Yeah, Chernika's up. They got to get Chernika down and conscious. So this one's going to take, let me see if it can.
Not my girl, Chernika.
Yeah, with, 5 feet out. Two dart attacks.
With this advantage, I'm prone.
I did skip your turn. I am so sorry. It's your turn, Talix.
Thank you. I would like to say, I guess we have to be unconscious if you're going to drag us to your sanctuary. I reckon. And I'm just going
to... I think you're dragging us to our sanctuary. I think they're trying to get us off this island. But who knows? Who knows?
Does it seem like they've been targeting Chernika and Sigmund from the right from the left?
Oh, for sure. For sure.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm just gonna hit the thing with my dagger. Oh, or my sword. Sorry. 14.
14 would hit. They're going to parry, increase their AC. 17. 17 will miss with the... No, because they can only do it for one attack, so 17 will hit.
You mean like a fighter?
13.
Or like a monk. 13 points of damage?
Yeah.
All right.
Extra attack.
Yeah.
I'm just recklessing. So,
multiple hit. Good. You're targeting this one in front of you?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh my god, yeah, he's out of here, Talix.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Anything else on your turn?
Yeah, I'm gonna take one attack opportunity with advantage. Move. Right there.
25.
Yeah, that hits.
You're actually going to take two attacks of opportunity.
Yep.
So 6 points, half to 3. And then the second one. 24?
Yeah, hits.
7 more for half to 3. Anything else?
No, that's it.
All right, this one is going to move up. So sorry for skipping. It is going to do what I said last time, make two attacks on Chernika.
Disadvantage because I'm prone.
Disadvantage because you're considered prone. Ten.
No.
And 17.
Yes. Oh, it's been good.
And going. 8 more poison.
I'm down.
Alright, Chernika is down again. Sigmund is unconscious, Chernika's unconscious. This monk is going to go right here. Make two attacks on Odavin.
He can try, shit.
He did try.
It. He did it.
He did it, 25. Nah. And that one! 10 points of bludgeoning. Give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
Ooh. Ah.
13. DC is 15. You're Whoa. Pushed back 30 feet, brother.
Damn.
Dig it.
And then his rest of his movement is going to come right here. This one. He's going to make two blow dart attacks on Talix. 18 and 19.
Okay.
This is going to be poison damage. For minimum of 10 poison damage, give me a con save. Talix, you are poisoned, my brother.
Alright.
And this last one. And now that is officially all of them outside of the map. This one's going to dash, get 60 feet up. Pop it around. This one going to move here. Two poison dart attacks on Talix. Fourteen and 11.
But they have advantage.
Is it weapon like melee or ranged as well?
Doesn't say.
Oof. All right. And let's see for that one for the second attack at advantage because the first one's gonna miss. 17 to hit.
17 hits.
Cool. Five poison. And then this one over here is going to do the same thing at advantage twice with the blow dart. Now they don't have the banner there. 22. He was. And 20. For 12 points of poison damage. Yeah, this is when it gets annoying on my end. Actually, Nova's right there as well. Two attacks on Nova.
Mm-hmm.
24. I'm just rolling pretty good. And 13?
Yep. Or not 13, sorry. 24.
Oh, so 24 will hit. For 6 poison, give me a con save.
Okay. Ooh, probably not a pass. Let's see.
You need 15.
Yeah, 8.
8, you're poisoned. This one is going to make two attacks on Odavin. 16 and 24.
Yeah,
minimum damage for 5 bludgeoning. Give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
16.
Succeeds. Yeah, this one. I'm just going to be a bit wonky. Make two attacks on Talix at advantage. 24. And that 19. They're going to be bludgeoning, so this is halved. to 17, half to 8. Give me an acrobatics or athletics check. You have advantage on athletics. When he succeeds. Oh, actually, let me go back, because then he is going to use his flurry of blows. Another nat 19. Oh my god, even at advantage, 14. An additional 8 points, half to 4.
Yep.
This one going to move up. 2 blow darts on Nova. Yeah, the difficulty with this, guys, is they're not hard to take out. It's just hard to stay with them.
Mm-hmm.
10 to hit Nova. And oh my god, both miss, and 11.
Mm-hmm.
This one, he has the movement. He's going to come here, pick Sigmund up. He is going to dash right here. Sybil, he's within 5 feet, so you don't trigger an opportunity attack. But you see him carrying Sigmund, booking it. This one is going to come right here. Can you get to Nova? He absolutely can. Let's see if I can be cheeky. I absolutely can be cheeky. 2 attacks on Nova. God, not one.
Mm-mm.
And 18.
I got just hit.
Cool. Give me an athletics or acrobatics check as you take 6 points of bludgeoning. Fails it by 1. I need a 15.
Oh. Damn. Okay.
Pushed back 30 feet. Odavin, it is your turn.
Ping ponged.
That's, you're literally just being ping ponged, y'all.
Blink, 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 blink.
Just blink, blink, ding, 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 ding.
I'm gonna move up just so I don't fucking ping pong you further back.
You need an opportunity attack from this one.
Yeah, you're hitting.
That's one.
Ouch.
Not good. Not great.
D6. 13 points of blush.
I'm going to, as an actor, attempt to repair the gun.
Cool, give me a Tinker Tools check.
Yeah, 19. So the gun is repaired. Perfect. That's my action. As a bonus action.
Bonus.
I'm going to just put out the hand as soon as I finish repairing the gun. I stowed away really quickly. I just put a hand out, and this little tiny circle of fire appears over the monk that's holding Sigmund, and it emboldens into this little insignia of the dragon mask that just stays above his head. I'm gonna Hunter's Mark him.
Hunter's Mark him. Okay.
Yeah, that's cool.
He is Hunter's Marked.
That's a good idea.
Alright. This monk is a risky one, but... Well, no, he can just action disengage and move 30 instead of the full 60.
We're making our way downtown.
Walking fast, faces passing them home.
This one is going to go 30. Hold his action for when Talix gets close. He's going to make an attack. This one will go 25. And you see Talix, they're barring your way. This one's going to attempt to make 2 attacks at advantage because reckless. Oh my god, 12 and 16. Talix, 16 to hit?
Yes, it's.
Cool, this is going to be bludgeoning for 5, half to 2 bludgeoning. Give me an acrobatics or athletics.
Okay.
Oh my god, Talix. Talix, they're trying to hit you with this, like, palm strike to, like, push you back, and it's just, like, hitting a fucking tree. It's just, oh, God. That one's dad's turn. Sybil, it is your turn. You are within 5 feet of this guy, 10 feet from Sigmund. Can't hear you.
Yeah, I was muted. Okay. Looking around, yeah. I know. This guy looks kind of rough.
There's definitely some scheming whenever Juice goes, I know. There's always that combat scheming in the basement when someone goes like, do I do that? Okay.
I know, that's so true.
Bonus action healing word Sigmund first.
Okay.
As an action, I will, since I can, I'll prime the savagery him and then make it non-lethal.
Non-lethal. He dies!
He dies.
Non-lethally. That's a 30.
Yeah. Thing. It hits.
How do you die non-lethally?
Take 22 points of poison damage.
Yeah, he's out of there and he drops Sigmund to the ground. Sigmund no longer unconscious. He may get a turn.
I may! For the you first may. Time this entire encounter.
You had a turn.
No, I didn't!
Oh, well.
Ah,
oh, well.
I'm just gonna stand here and just try to...
So sorry. Cool, right cool. I'm so sorry. Alright, is that your turn, Sybil?
That's all I can do for now.
Okay, this one... Yeah, Talix is gonna be a problem. Two poison dart attacks on Talix. Thirteen for the, I keep forgetting to roll that advantage. 13 for the first one.
Miss.
Oh my god, 15 for the second one?
Miss.
God damn it! Nova, it's your turn.
Okay. So, I've been trying to figure out what I'm gonna do this entire time. Cause like, we're split on Trunika and
Sigmund. Yeah, it's hard,
but
man.
Let's see. Let me do a ruler. I can move 30 feet.
Mm-hmm.
I can dash 30 more feet. Still won't be that great. But yeah, I think I'll try to help with Trunika because there's a lot more guys on Trunika and Talix. So I'll go 30 feet this way. Bonus action, dash 30 more feet. And then I will Eldritch Blast the first guy holding Trunika.
Mm-hmm.
And then I might choose others if this does them in.
Okay. Make your attack.
Let me roll that. Is that 20?
Hits.
Oh, wait. I'm rolling with disadvantage, though. Sorry.
Because of attack. Yep. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Oh, it was also a 13.
Hits.
Right? So 20 hits. And then I will grasp a Padar him back towards
roll damage,
me.
Roll damage first.
Yeah, if this doesn't kill him.
Non-lethally.
Not kill him. Non-lethally kills him.
Non-lethally. Takes him out.
10. Okay, cool. And then I'll do my two, I'll just blast on the ones closest to her. So this, like, how do I ping again?
I'll left click
this
and hold.
One and this one.
Cool.
So I'll do one for each. Oh, that I need to roll that with disadvantage. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, and it was a natural 20, ooh, but it's actually a 5.
So 14. 14 will hit. They can't parry
ranged
attacks.
So I'll roll the damage on that.
Uh-huh.
Hang on. Roll the damage on that. And then I'll roll my third attack with disadvantage, because for some reason it's not fucking working for me.
Hit? Are you targeting the same one or a different one?
A different one. So the
cool.
one
you got
right
it.
Here and yep. here. So I rolled a 22 and a 14, so that's a 14 for the last
hits.
One. Okay,
hits.
It hits. Cool. And then that's the damage on those two. So the first one gets 15, the second one gets 9.
Alright.
And I'm going to do repelling blast on them and move them 10 feet away from me.
All right.
We're just ping-ponging each other.
Yeah. Anything else?
No, that's going to have to be my turn.
All right. This one is going to move up. Yeah, two. God, that Reckless is rough with a lot of enemies, Talix. I'm so sorry, buddy. I'm so sorry, my beautiful Count Dracula brethren. Nat 20. Nat 20 on the first one. And then 15.
Misses.
So this is poison damage. 10 points of poison damage.
Okay.
Give me a con save.
I have 3 hit points left.
Oh my god. Well, I think you're already... Nova, give me a con save as well. At the end of your turn, you're already poisoned, I believe, Talix.
Yeah, Talix is already poisoned.
So no con save.
Natural 20, though. Natural 5.
I'll apply it to your next turn. At the end of your turn is when you make the save. I'll apply it there. Still Poison Nova. This one's turn is going to come here.
No!
One attack on Sigmund at advantage.
Yeah, that's all that Ugo need.
Please.
You know the game, man. You know the game.
You know the game.
24 on Sigmund.
I'm down.
What are your hit points?
Oh, yeah. What are my hit points?
Did you add healing?
No.
Bro.
Sibyl.
I gave you, you 10. You took 10. I got your back.
Okay.
You know what? I'll just keep track for you at this point. I got it. It's
good. And then the second attack on Sibyl.
Yeah.
21 to hit.
Hit.
Oh. 9 points of bludgeoning. Give me an acrobatics or athletics check.
Oh, come on. Not this again. Anything but this.
Gotta get out the way, man. Gotta get out the fucking way. They're hard. Even Ryota. 15 is what you need, baby. Unfortunately, that does mean he's gonna make the 2 flurry of blows because you're still here. Hey, even Ryota was like, these guys are rough. Nat 1 on the first one.
Yeah.
And 24 on the second one. Oh, 6 Damn. Plus 4 for 10.
We're all spread out now, too. Yeah.
That was kind of the point. That's what they're built to spread you guys out. Yeah.
And we are...
That's this one's turn. Alex, it is your turn, brother. No longer disadvantaged. Oh, well, no, still disadvantaged on attacks. Until the end of your turn. Because your poison ends at the end of your turn. I'll give you the nat 20.
Okay. I will just bite them.
Okay.
I will non-lethally? Just bite them.
Non-lethally. Yeah, I'll you bite non-lethally.
Right?
I'm raging. I'm a rabid dog. I'm biting their arms.
Okay. Maybe
dude, we're doing this non-lethally though.
It is.
Barbarian's going barbarian.
It is. Oh, it is. It's He's just biting their arms like a feral dog, but non-lethally.
It doesn't do much damage. Okay, believe me.
Non-feral.
Make an attack. Make a attack at disadvantage.
That's fine. I don't think 10 hits.
10 does not hit, unfortunately.
Ah, so yeah.
Anything else?
Nope.
All right. This one. This guy's in the back.
Actually, I will give. Who's 60 feet? I will give Sibyl a bardic inspiration.
Okay. Hell yeah. This one's gonna do 2 shots on Odavin.
Disadvantage.
A disadvantage, though, yeah. 9 is just not gonna hit. We'll just see, though. Cool. And then a disadvantage.
It's a disadvantage, yeah.
15. That one misses. It is the Singing Blade's turn.
Oh, God. Oh, my goodness. Don't move
Snoopy! 55. What are the odds?
You
see that? Do you see that highlight color under her token?
No.
No. Oh, you don't see it? Okay, just making sure. Just making sure. What color is your
ultimate? Yes, I do.
It's
green.
Blue, right?
Orange.
I might have saw it. She dashes forward to Chernika. Is Chernika, are you healed? Or are you still are you unconscious?
I don't think so. I think I'm unconscious.
Yeah.
Okay. Nova and Talix, give me a perception check. Is that disadvantage? Well, Talix is not poisoned anymore.
I'm at disadvantage, though.
Disadvantage. Give me a perception check.
Natural one.
Okay. You see she draws the blade out, bends down, and picks Chernika up over her shoulder, and she's carrying the blade as to not in like a threatening way, but definitely in a threatening way. Not like I'm gonna kill this one, but definitely like you come closer, I'm gonna fight you. That's what you're getting just on a passive insight is like I'm not killing this one, but if you come closer, I'm gonna fight you. Like, I'm gonna beat your ass. And she starts to just turn around. Just Cherny gets carried over her shoulder.
AJ, post the hero force. What does she look like?
I will eventually. Chernika, you are unconscious, but Talix and Nova, you see that half of her face, it looks like Zuko's scar. It's just this almost like necrosis skin. It's glazed over purple. The one eye is closed and it extends from the top of her crown all the way down one side of her face. Other than that, she is a beautiful woman, but that one side is gnarled.
Does it look like spirit eyes?
Well, what?
I'm going to say it's hard because you've never seen the physical, other than Sigmund's arm, you haven't seen the full effects of it. It doesn't look like Sigmund's arm, though, is what I'll give Nolan.
Sorry, I'm off on it there, so I don't know. But yeah. Didn't we see Jekyll fucked up?
You did! You absolutely did! Yeah, it does look similar to Jekyll's on his face when it was extended out. Absolutely right, you did. This one will move. Yeah, one dart attack on Talix and then one on Nova. Mm-hmm. Talix 21 to hit.
Hits.
And Nova 18 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
Talix, you're taking 7 points of poison.
I'm
done. Talix is down. Again, Talix, this one hits you right in your wrist. Nova, 5 points of poison. It hits you right in the wrist, Talix. You drop the weapon as it hits to the ground. The blade pierces in the dirt. As you lock up, your muscles try to break out of it. You're... And then you fall to one knee, still slowly, kind of like a dragon's dying breath, what it's like, and it tries to get up. You're on one knee until you two fall into slumber. Sigmund, oh my god, Sigmund. Sigmund's unconscious again.
Again.
Unconscious. This one is going to come here. Two attacks on Sybil. 11.
Nope.
And 15.
Oh, that one will, yeah.
9 points of bludgeoning.
Yeah, I'm okay still.
This one is not going to push you away. This one is actually going to do two more flurry of blows on you.
That's good.
19 and 11.
The 19 will hit, but I'm going to use Shadowy Defense, and Gert's actually going to full protect me this time. So I get plus 2 to my AC until the end of my next turn.
Cool. This one, who's the current with this? Boom, boom.
Six, got it.
This one is going to come here. You see that the singing blade hands Chernika off. With a slight nod, this monk does a deep bow carrying Chernika and is going to attempt to action dash the rest of its movement. And she turns. This one, Talix as well, is affected. Ooh, Talix is also affected. He's going to do 2 dart attacks on Nova.
Fuck. Talix
14
is down,
right? Yep. And 21.
21 hits.
For 5 points of poison?
Yerp. Still up.
Still up. Holy shit, no, what a turk! This one's gonna get to Talix. Action.
Oh. He's not about to lift him up, is he?
Oh, he can.
That's crazy. Talix is a big
man.
Dude.
Takes love him.
Like,
yeah.
Like,
both
over their heads.
That's 10 and then 60 here.
The 4Ds carry the big like thing that like the royal.
Fucking Oompa Loompas.
This one, 2 attacks on Nova with the blow dart. 18.
Yes, that hits.
And 11.
11 does not.
It was very admirable not going for non-lethal damage. 7 points of poison. It also made this fight a lot harder.
Yeah,
7 points of poison.
Yeah, I'm still up.
But very admirable. Very admirable. And it was a decision that will have ramifications.
Really?
In the best way. Or the worst way. We'll see.
We'll find out.
2 more darts on Nova. 16. And 18?
18 hits.
8 points of poison.
Alright, it's looking rough. I've got 12 hit points left.
Oh my god.
I've been doing kind of good this fight, though.
You have been doing really good. Odavin, four attacks on you. Or actually, Odavin is also affected. Yes, four attacks on you.
What am I affected by? Spirit Rot.
You have Spirit Rot.
Ah.
16. 18. 24. And 22.
I'll shield the last one, so one hit.
One hit. 7 points of bludgeoning.
Okay, real quick. Sorry, I'm using one of these right now. Yeah, I will, I'll use the Dragon Clutch, focus to, move, help, to teleport 15 feet after using a spell.
Cool. Cool. Alright, this one is gonna do Nova's not affected, so 4 attacks coming to you, Nova.
Oh boy. This might do me in.
24.
Yep.
18.
Yep.
17.
17, no. 18, yeah.
And 18, so, I'm probably so 3.
Going down. I've got 12 hit points.
Okay, so the minimum they can do is 15. So Nova, oh. You go unconscious again, non-lethal, but you are down.
I think Sigmund has done the best.
Bludgeoning.
Well, no, how much was it, sorry?
Seven. This one, 4 more on you. You still have shield up.
Yeah, 24, I see.
Misses. Hits. Misses. And misses.
3 9s, holy crap.
Honestly, and minimum damage, 5 points of bludgeoning. This one, Sybil does not have. Sybil does not have Ra. It's the boys and Chernika, actually.
Yep.
Yeah.
Nova
doesn't
either.
Nova doesn't.
Yep. Nova and Sybil are clean.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. He'll see Sybil's already putting her weapons up right now. Like I said, it's just like.
Her. Oh, you're. Sybil, yeah, you're already putting your hands up.
Yeah, she's already putting her hands up.
Cool.
We'll just let you take us wherever it is we have to go. Apparently, I don't want to kill you, and that's what it'll take.
24 on Odavin.
Okay, can you roll like one lower to shoot it?
Sorry. I gave you a 9. 24. So 2. I'm sorry, brother. It's a nat 17. What do you want me to do?
Okay, roll on that 16. That's what I want you to do.
Ah! 16 points of bludgeoning. It is your turn.
Watch him leave me in symbol.
No.
No.
All right. No, fucking. I will Yeah. I'll fucking as a bonus action. Actually, no. Fuck that. I'm not sending those small slots. I'm just gonna just as a free action. I don't think it takes anything to undo it. I'll just kind of magically like slam the actual like staff of the broom into the ground. It kind of like magically like unfurls, and I'll just kind of like twist it like a bow staff and kind of put it behind my back again.
Is that your turn?
Yep.
You see a confused look in the monk's eyes. He kind of turns back towards Singing Blade while the other one is still looking at you. And then he goes for another attack to knock you out. You can give me an insight check.
Bitch.
I can try.
Yeah, that's the motto.
That's good for me. 13.
13? Yeah, okay. It's not a malice. It's not a malicious thing. It's more like you can't see where you're being taken to. You're going to have to go to sleep. You see what I'm saying? It's like, if it was us, like, we're not going to show you where we're taking you. You're going to sleep. And he clocks you in the back of the head as you...
Fucking crazy.
He leans, he picks you up, and on his turn, he's going to start. That's crazy.
That's crazy.
They have Talix, they have... Well, Sigma needs to get out. Nova is down. It's just Sybil. Odavin's down.
Yeah, Sybil's the only one.
It's just Sybil. Sybil, are you
my old freaking eyebrow thing, and she'll just put an eye band back on. She has it in her pocket all the time.
They turn towards the singing blade as...
Please don't hit me.
They just leave you, Sybil.
They just leave me standing here?
They leave you.
What about me? Do they leave me too?
Sybil, you see Nova as well. They just step over her and they're carrying the four people that were affected with spirit rot. Okay. All of the monks start to disappear. We're ending initiative.
I'll go heal Nova.
As
when they're all gone, or like as they're leaving?
That's what I'm gonna move everyone before Sybil and Nova, you guys reconcile. I'm gonna move to where everyone on the battlefield is. Every monk has one person they're carrying, and they're in a perfect unison running, carrying these four.
What about
the other
leader?
Ones have already darted. She is staying. She's staying back, watching you two intently. But they are heading out.
Oh, I'll take my eye thing off, but they're not taking me. Can I meet her eyes? What's her body like?
She's
like she's just stopping us.
A warrior, stoic, like not like I'm doing this duty because I have to, but it's like I am. It's very much like a paladin aura kind of thing, where it's like this is what I do. But she doesn't move towards you. She just stands there.
Are you gonna do any harm to them?
You are trespassers in this sacred land.
I apologize for that. You have my friends now.
Leave.
Give Nova a quick. I'll give you 70. I'll
just give 70? Nova, you... Oh my God. The bones crack into place with the healing magic again. Your rib cage, many of them haven't been broken, now slowly start to heal magically, but it's still tight. She just stands there as you all watch the other four being carted away slowly.
We are not here out of disrespect or hostility. We're here out of desperation, and so are they.
I know why you are here. As many others before you. You have come to cure the thief's curse. However, you two have no stake in this.
What do you mean?
Our friends are our stake.
And they will be cared for under my watch. But I will not allow outsiders, foreigners, to this sacred place.
Why are you caring for them? Aren't they also outside us?
They suffer the thief's curse. It is our duty to help those that come here afflicted by it. That is all you need to know.
They have no way home unless we're here.
Steal. And it's not, you get a sense, both Nova and Sybil especially with your passive insight, it's not malicious at all, where she's like, fuck y'all. It's literally like I'm gonna put it out of game. Like, think of her perspective, right?
Right.
If you're if you're the leader of this sacred place, doesn't matter who you are, right? It's like, this is my job. It's like, if I'm security, I'm not supposed to let anyone get through the doors. Ah, you lost your wallet in there? Sorry. That's the type of thing. It's like a security guard, essentially.
Listen, you don't know us, but we also don't know you. How do we know that they're going to be safe?
You don't.
We have similar customs back home. Remember, Nova?
She turns to you. If you compare yourself to this land once more time, which I will take your tongue.
Easy.
I understand why you are here. Your kind has come here before, and this blade has felled many of them. I do not wish to fell another one with it today.
Well, at least I get that kind of sentiment from this. No disrespect intended. Let's walk for now. She does not want us here.
just leave. We don't even know if they're going to survive whatever the fuck they're doing. What if we never see them again? We can't trust these people. We don't even know them.
Yes, but we're not in a position to punch our way through them either.
Just do nothing.
Not doing nothing.
I want your word that you won't harm them.
I do not make deals with honorless fools.
Not a deal, it's a promise.
Then let me amend my previous statement. I do not make promises to honorless fools. You are selfish. You lack honor. You lack respect. Your friend, although she a witch, carries more of that than you do. And yet you brandish a blade and arms, and you think yourself a warrior.
We defended ourselves.
Yes, and you did quite well. But a dog defends itself from someone hitting it. You are a cat pretending to be a lion. Do not step to a lion.
Sybil, we can't leave. They'll kill them.
She's kind of giving you a look like... like, let's walk and talk away from them, where they're standing and hear all of our words.
How do we even leave? We don't even know the next place out of here.
I know that I want to be, respectfully, as far from her as she would like me to be right now. That's what I know.
It's not the end.
You're right. But we can't lose our heads every time someone gets the better of us.
They don't return, we're raising hell. She'll get up and turn away.
Okay. Nova and Sybil.
Sorry.
Where are we even going? I don't even know.
Just walking.
That is my question to you,
of,
yeah.
Yeah, just walking opposite
the way you came.
Great. Yeah, cool. Distance from her for now.
Cool.
I'm just trying to break like her earshot basically.
Absolutely. Just, like, you break it after like 5 minutes as she turns, yeah. But she doesn't, you can feel that aura extending out like I still got my eye on you. As she gets closer, one thing I will note, you see that the Hayori and Hakama that she's wearing are covered in these beautiful red and yellow eyes. Kind of like Ganon's eye in like Breath of the Wild. It's like that, like all of the eyes around it. And this beautiful flurrying pattern.
I will remember that. Juice pulling up his notes. And pick like speed. Let's go!
Hey!
Yeah, she was.
Nova and Sybil, is there anything you two do, or are you just walking back, aimlessly looking for something? What do you, just so I understand?
I don't know, we're not allowed to...
Like, as soon as we're 10 minutes away from her, just so, like, we have protection from other people just fucking jumping on us. Jesus Christ! Okay, so...
Non-lethal was the honorable thing to do. It also made the fight so much difficult because you could have just fireballed seven of them and take them out.
Yeah,
exactly. You know what I mean? So it's
but
hard.
But apparently we're selfish thieves for that.
She said you are. She said you
yeah.
are.
No, I'm sure she said that, yeah. Even though I
we're
didn't
on the rag on
single one of our men.
I'm a witch, so everyone just hates on the witch.
Yeah.
Max,
burn
okay.
the witch.
It's what you asked for! Don't blame Juice, it's what you asked for!
It is what I asked for.
Okay. The rest of you four, you don't know how much time has elapsed, but you wake up. Your wrists are kind of tight, your ankles are kind of tight, you're bound in loose knots. Not like restricting you like this or like this, but you're definitely bound to a bed, kind of like one arm. There is some slack on it, so you can move. You can't just, like, fucking go like this, but you have some movement.
Yeah.
You know, at first, you're like, what the fuck? Okay. But you feel Odavin, Sigmund, Chernika, Talix. That bubbling in your chest is gone. Your sinuses are clear. Even Sigmund, you haven't taken a clear breath in years. Maybe the majority of your adult life. But you cough just based on how crisp your smell is. Just yeah. You understand it. It's like, holy fuck.
Yeah, is there like a monk around? Like, no, anyone
you
just...
guys are in this room. They're basically okay. Two, four beds. The yep. Rest of the room is empty. It looks like these beds were placed here for you okay. Four. And there's a small little, like, bowl of water, this very mm-hmm. Wide bowl of water by each of you. There's a cloth that's been dabbed there, and there's empty, tiny little bottles with some residue in them.
Do I still have, like, my gas mask and, like, my gauntlet and stuff
on? No, you guys have been stripped of your gear.
Okay, cool.
You're just in your clothes.
Yep. Just dangling.
You're like in a bed and it's a comfy feather yeah. Bed, but you all four awake and you can breathe. That bubbling is gone. Your vigor is back. Chernika, your ability scores go back. You four have been cured of spirit rot. The room you find yourself in is opulent, yet simple. It's a wooden tatami mat, almost like bamboo derivative. You're in these beautiful beds. The blankets, they're not pulled over you, but they're covering your feet just and like your shins to like give you that warmth feeling. There's no like decor. It's like everything here has a purpose. There's sliding doors on either side, and you see shadows move by. They sense your movement, and then one rushes off, their feet pitter-pattering on the wooden floor. Is there anything you four want to do as you're here?
Yeah, I think, like, being able to actually breathe for the first time in what seems like forever, like, I think Sigmund just kind of, like, starts, like, you ever get, like that, like, relieved, like, laugh, you know, where it's like, holy shit, like,
yeah.
This is what it's like to breathe.
Sigmund, you're maybe, other than your brother who got it through other means, you're probably the first Taxius to be cured of spirit rot in generations.
Which is insane. Like, holy shit.
Anything you four are doing before I move forward?
Yeah. So, this is what it's like to actually breathe normally.
How's it feel?
I don't know. I never want to stop breathing. But more than ever, if we can get this cure to everyone, so they're not fully stripped of this.
I don't know how feasible it is to get everyone here. I think our best chance for a mass solution is still...
Yes, of course, yes, but... There is a cure. There is a cure other than the Wish Runner.
There is. These people know it, apparently.
And at this point, I guess we realize that Sybil and Nova aren't here.
Yeah, they're not here, nowhere to be seen. Yep.
I guess judging since our two healthy companions aren't here, they must have known we're infected with the spirit rot. But... what had happened in...
I was out the moment the fight began, really.
There were a lot. A dozen or more of them. And then their leader showed up. I didn't really get a chance to see how strong she was, but... Well... When I gave myself up, they sucker-punched me in the back of the head.
Is everyone at least still alive? Everyone's on both alive. Sides?
On both sides.
Good. I'm glad.
Chernika, Talix?
I'm just trying to perceive where I am.
Yeah, in this room, there's two sliding doors. The room is as described, and that's really it.
Hello? Anyone out there?
I mean, you see your companions, but that's it.
All right. Oh, you are here. Did I snore? Oh. Oh,
Chernika,
right.
Anything. Chernika?
Chernika?
What? Sorry.
Anything? Anything from you?
Nope.
Okay. Eventually, one of the doors slides open, and you see the same woman flanked by two monks on either side. She takes one step into the room, the other monks, they flank, and they slowly begin to unbound your knots. You have been cured. You must go.
How did you do this?
Please, yes.
And I don't mean to take some secret or anything like that, but this is quite a feat.
We have our ancient ways of curing this curse.
AJ, please. Can I fix my hit points
you four can take a long rest.
Yeah.
Sybil and Nova, I'll say you're getting to, like, it's nighttime for you guys. You start breaking up a little camp somewhere in these beautiful cherry trees. I'm going to get to you two in a moment.
Okay.
Would you be opposed to us taking this cure outside if that's possible?
Yes.
Okay.
Please.
This cure will stay here.
You must teach me how this is possible. For the past years, decades, my family has been struggling with this sickness. If there are innocent people who are infected by the crooked countess, I have to help them, please.
Bardic inspiration on Sigmund.
You pick up when you say crooked countess, there's the slight, like, the steel face, the raw iron mask breaks slightly. No. If this cure leaves this land, then you will do as all men do. You will weaponize it. You will commercialize it. If not you, someone else. And then eventually, more people will get sick and more people will die. And the people who hold the cards will only deal them out to those that can pay for them. This is a sacred place. Getting this cure is worthy of one's determination and conviction. Things that you all lack, but we could not let you die of this slow disease while you are in our land.
I have lived with this my whole life. Those innocents who were given 10 days before the rot consumes them fully. They do not deserve that fate. This is my sin. This is my family's sin. Please. Even if it means if it means giving them a chance.
You can beg all you want.
Infect me again.
No.
I don't care. I don't care what happens to me.
Why would I do that? No. If they wish for a cure, then they can come here and get one. But the method will not leave this land.
We can work with that. Are you opposed to us bringing affected people here?
Yes.
You just said that they yes. come here for treatment.
Yes, if they come here. But you will not ferry people onto this land who are undeserving. Because then, you become exactly what I just said. You become those that hold the cards. I know you think your intentions are good. I am not the one who decides who is worthy of a cure. You all were deemed worthy, and so you were cured. It is that simple.
If I may ask, was it Lo who deemed us worthy?
Do not speak the Wishwarner's name in vain, if you'd be so kind.
I'm sorry,
I did not mean...
the
utmost respect for that spirit.
You're right, I did not mean any disrespect. I just...
This was not a personal decision. The Wishrunner deemed you all worthy of life, and so you were granted it. If they deem others unworthy, they will not have the cure.
What can you tell us about the Countess? Seems you're at least a little familiar.
The thief. Why the Wishrunner decided in its benevolence to cure one of their descendants, I do not know and I will not question. But if you wish to seek atonement for the sins of your family, the note goes much farther than you.
I do not know what sin the Crooked Countess. I assume it was stealing whatever the spirit rot truly is from this land. But what I do know is she and my brother are dead set on finding the spirit who lives in these lands. I do not know what their wish will... I do not know what her wish will be. I want to do what I can to stop them.
And then do what you can to stop them. But you may leave here immediately.
By stopping them, will it cure those that the Crooked Countess infected with her rot?
I do not know.
I assume... Lo has some... not great feelings towards the Countess. Am I correct in that? They seem to have old beef.
The thief, yes.
What if we were planning on bringing her down? It's our next stop after we didn't have a clock over our heads. If we do that, and I don't know if you're the person I should be speaking to, but if we do that, and it doesn't help these people, could Lo heal them in return for us making her not a problem anymore?
The thief is not a problem for the Wishrunner. That is what our purpose here is.
You don't seem to like people here, which I understand. And the more people she infects, the more people that are going to come here. So if she stops infecting people, you all get less unwanted visitors. Yes?
There are many before you who have come here, and many who the Wishrunner has deemed unworthy. The future will make no difference to that. Whether the thief lives or dies will make no difference to that.
Can I may be permitted to learn the history of the thief and the Wishrunner? I do not know my family's history in that matter.
Will you agree to leave after I tell you?
Yes.
Sybil and Nova.
Ah!
Anything you two want to do as you're setting up camp for the night?
Well, we can't go home because I used heal on you. So that was our way home for today and also the Druid's Grove. So now we're going to sleep out here in the dirt.
What am I, level 3? Ugh.
Ugh.
Disgusting.
Sybil loves it. It's fine. This is a great place to sleep, I imagine.
I'm gonna get... What's your passive insight, Nova and Sybil?
9.
And your passive perceptions. 9. Passive perception. Oh my god, girl!
My passive perception and insight are 15, both.
Okay, Sybil, you're on Team Grozzet. There's only one other person you've seen carry a sword that long.
Yep.
Oh no.
Kind of looking back on it, the movement, the gait, the assuredness, the way they drew their weapon, very similar to Zentetsuken.
God, that's crazy. Like,
that might be his kid or some family member descendant at this point.
Sybil, on a 15, the singing blade's movements are polished. Perfect. They're a perfect samurai. There's not a single hair out of place. There's not a single movement. Every movement is in a crescent. Just this glidingness. Just that comes naturally. When you move using kendo or yaido, you walk in a crescent. So much so that after years and years and years of being in a fighting stance, moving like that for the quickness, it's like she's always on the ball of her feet. Always moving with this grace. It's something that Zentetsuken lacked the last time you saw him.
Some member of Zentetsuken's. Best know it. Does Sybil know the legacy of Zentetsuken? Because, like, that was before her time, I think.
Nova would, just like what he was. Like, growing up, Nova, that guy was the warrior. He was the, like, right-hand warrior of the Emperor. He also murdered the Emperor, the previous Ryota's father. He murdered him, and that's why it was such a big deal, was because it was like, you're his sworn sword. Essentially, what Rangetsu is to the Shogun, Zentetsuken was to the Emperor, which is probably to the Emperor, not the figurehead of Ryota's sister, but the actual, like, past Emperor. That's probably the highest honor a warrior in Xilao could have.
Yeah.
And he threw it away for some reason. No one knows why. There's so many different rumors, but no one knows exactly why.
I imagine if we were to ask him these days, he's a little too far gone.
Probably, doesn't help our current situation either. Are you able to scry on them?
I could do that, but, I don't know if the spirit, as I know them, would in that domain, would be very happy with me sticking my eyes in there now that I'm thinking about it as Sybil for a second.
What do you mean?
This is Lo's domain. All of them. It's his. Worshippers of him, right? That was what those symbols were, I think. that she was wearing? I don't know. I just feel like if I were to try to scry in that area, I wouldn't get a more than just a no. It would probably be a smack in the eyes.
What are we going to do? We have no idea if they're even alive.
Oh, they're going to be alive. I have a feeling her honor won't let her kill them when they're already sick.
We don't know her.
No, but we know samurai. Right? We've seen other people that are honor-bound. She carries herself very similarly to them.
You get similar vibes to Arlen, strangely enough, from this woman.
Yeah.
Like, kind of like a code of honor, like code of ethics.
I was like, she doesn't hate us, even. There was even no malice in her voice. Danny. It was just a point of fact. And she's not wrong. From her position, I am a witch. I am a thing. They don't like me. You know what I mean? It is known. Like, the Shogun Misaki doesn't like me. So therefore, anybody that is a samurai of any kind isn't going to like me. That's just the way it is. We'll see. I mean, I could try. I mean, I'll scry on them if you want me to, but there might be consequences.
It's up to you. Either way, we can't do anything until the morning.
Yeah, we're stuck for now. I do wonder, did Zentetsu can do that? If you were the right hand of the Emperor, I mean, arguably the hand of the Emperor at that point, you probably have more power than he does, really. I mean, he's the voice, but you are the hand, you know what I mean?
When she was speaking to me specifically, like, did it feel like there was any familiarity or something, like, with where I come from, what I'm doing, or anything?
That's a very great question, Nova. Piecing it back, because you guys haven't had nothing to do, really. You've just been walking. I'm going to say just, like, running it through over and over and over again in your mind. It's not about you specifically.
Yeah.
Right? But it's like she knew what you were. Like, she sensed it, or...
Do I think it's more about, like, my class, my race, anything specifically?
So as a paladin, you can detect certain creatures, right? One of those creatures is aberrations, fiends, demons. So it's like she probably picked up, like,
warlock
of a demon.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably. That's why we were both looked at on with disdain, is that I'm literally a witch if you're...
As good as a demon, yeah.
Finger. Speaking of, if we wanted to get more information about Zentetsuken.
Speaking of, I need everyone except Sybil and Nova to deafen, please.
Alright.
Oh.
Vol, if you could please. 4. Back in this room, you see the singing blade sits. Get her name. I'm trying to find her name. I had it. Yes. Ilmaro Taxis.
Hey!
She came to this land long ago. She had lost the one she loved. She had attempted the trial of the Wishrunner and succeeded in capturing it. As the Wishrunner dictates, she was granted a wish. And what did she do with that wish? She wished to defy life and death. And wished for a man who died of natural causes to return to life. This selfish wish angered the Wishrunner. Lola, Wishrunner. And in its mercy, the man returned. But he wasn't the man she remembered. The body was still a cadaver. A lesson to teach your ancestor of humility. And potentially how to deal with loss and pain. Unfortunately, this lesson was not well received. Elmaro Taxis returned and once again completed the trial of the Wish Runner. This time, the wish was different. For you see, every time one completes the trial or attempts it, Lo becomes ever so evasive. But as one of only two people in history who have captured the Wish Runner twice, your ancestor wished for power almighty. And it was granted. Elmaro Taxis was given great arcane abilities. She was able to play a warden of life and death, bring back those under her watch who had died before their time, she stated. However, as the years went by, your ancestor realized the mistake of greed. For she could not die, she could not age. And yet, her skin became wrinkled. Her body became black. Nothing but a wretched corpse walking in fine regalia. I believe this drove her mad. As the thief's curse manifested within her, she was forced to an eternal torment. This sickness, this debilitating pain, and an eternal life. The Wish Runner had hoped that she would return once again, beg forgiveness, and wish what she should have wished in the first place. However, in her greed, she did not. She accumulated power, wealth, and she even learned to pass on her disease to others. The son she had sired with a corpse was born with it, their children as well, and so on and so forth. But eventually, those killed by someone afflicted with this thief's curse would rise again under the same curse themselves. And like a plague, it spread and spread and spread. Well, she says.
So everyone who whoever carries the thief's curse, whoever that person kills will also rise with the curse.
Yep.
If you may permit me to
ask. It never happened, but had Sigmund killed someone, they would have came back as a zombie. Never happened. But had Sigmund, like, killed someone, like a humanoid, they would have came back as a zombie.
I could have been a necromancer? Cool.
Not under your control.
Sag.
Eventually, that's why, like, throughout the campaign, I was putting you guys in positions to, like, kill people. Because if Sigmund killed someone, she would have gotten more to her ranks and more to her ranks and more to her ranks every person that you killed.
Are people still allowed to take the trial of the Wish Runner?
If they are deemed worthy by the Wish Runner.
I assume deemed worthy for the trial is a step further.
Sorry, I need your question one more time.
As he deemed me worthy for life, apparently. I assume being deemed worthy to take the trial is a step further.
There is a grove in this land. There lies Chukara, the great tree, said to be a connection to this realm and the spirit realm, where lost spirits arrive, focusing on Chukara. If the Wishrunner deems you worthy, will send you to her domain. There you may attempt to catch her.
Hold on. Uno momento, por favor.
I would like to do that, if you don't mind me walking around here a little longer.
Give me a persuasion check.
I am the honor guy. I am not the war guy. I am the honor guy. Same as that told something you don't want
to hear? The opposite.
Oh, okay.
I confirmed something I thought like a week ago. Odavin, you go first. Sorry.
If you can find the grove, then it is proof that the Wishrunner has deemed you wise enough.
Some questions, if I may. Through this story, you told how... Was it Imaro?
Ilmaro. I-L-L-M-A-R-R-O-W.
Ilmaro, okay. How Ilmaro Taxius could grant, bestow the thief's curse onto others. However, through that story, it made no mention of if she had the power to cure it. How is it that my brother, who, in full transparency, has sided with this being in search of whatever wish for a third time, how is it that he is restored to powers beyond, to a body beyond what any of my line knew?
If he did not come here, then he is not cured.
That is what I was afraid of.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Thank you.
If we are able to see this, to find this grove, may we, with your blessing, allow us to attempt it.
It is not my blessing to give. If you are shown the grove, then it is only because the Wishrunner has allowed you to see it. Two monks, they grab four burlap sacks. They begin to slowly place them over your heads. And you all begin to leave. Unless there's anything else any of you four want to do. Okay. You all are trudged out maybe like for a good 45 minutes to an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Till eventually you stop moving. And you're expectantly waiting for burlap sacks to come done. They never do. To one of you, whoever it be, like sheepishly...
Yeah.
Take it off and you're in the same clearing that you were before, during the fight. No one else around you.
It Tyler, you can reach out to them, can't you? Let them know we're okay.
Oh, that is correct. Uh-huh. I do have such an item in my possession.
Let them know that we're okay, and they can head home. I think we should look for this grove. If they have beef with those two, Low might too. It's something with this place.
As you're saying that, Odavin and Talix, Sybil and Nova, you guys are in your cots. You're like nearly asleep. And you feel a light kind of permeating through the little cot.
Oh, get up and...
Kind of opening the tent, you see a tiny little, maybe like a basketball size light. Like a little wisp. And it's moving very fast. Quick. Darting. And it dips into the trees.
If that's it looks like a will-o-wisp.
Then we are in luck. I'm gonna cast Tree Stride and chase it.
It's so fucking fast, Sybil. Like, you're about like Naruto bouncing from tree to tree. As Talix, you put your hand to your head, you're about to cast Sending, and then you four see this tiny little light in front of you.
Is that low?
This light, again, the size of a basketball, just dances and then darts into the shrubbery.
Oh, fuck you.
Oh, what we got a long rest, right?
You should be long rested, yes.
Let's go. All
right. Yeah, I'm chasing after it.
I got shit I can do. I got Mystic Step, Kinetic Jaunt, Adrenaline, 35 feet of movement. I'm booking it.
You guys are booking it. Talix at a 45 movement speed, Chernika with a dash. Sigmund, you trying to keep up, brother. But this thing is fucking like a bullet. Like, Odavin, yeah. You're just guesstimating. It's probably faster than a bullet from your weapon. It's so fucking fast. It disappears at times and you lose it. And kind of like a kid playing, it pops out a corner and then dips again into the shrubbery.
It's, like, it's trying not to lose us immediately.
It's trying not to let you lose it. The same thing for Sybil and Nova. Sybil, you're on top of a tree branch, you're looking around, and this thing right in your face, and then darts past. Go ahead, Talix.
While we're running, Odavin, you know we're in Feywild, right? We should maybe not be aware this might be an ambush.
We're not in the Feywild.
Aren't we? I thought we were in
Feywild.
My mind. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
This might be an ambush.
Still doesn't negate your point. Still could be.
So I'm
you're
running.
Still wrong, but you're also wrong.
Question.
Yeah.
As we're kind of running around, I assume Sigmund is in the back because he has not done cardio in his life.
But you can breathe, Sigmund.
I know.
You can breathe. You're running. You're like, holy fuck, I can. Oh, God. My chest is tight. And it's like, you know that crispness in your chest after you've ran like a mile? It's like, I have this. I can move.
Yeah, but anyway, so my point being, as I want to like try and slow down, and I want to take a look in my surroundings to try and find that tree that I remember seeing.
You're covered in shrubbery, man. Like, it's trees. It's a massive forest. The entire province is forest.
Oh. Can I try climbing a tree?
You try to climb a tree, you see your friends running, you don't see it. The canopy is like 30 feet, 40 feet high, brother.
I am trying to climb as high as I can. And
it's hard because you don't know which is like this massive tree because it blends in with every other tree up here. It's like trying to pick out one tree in the span of many.
Yeah. I guess my thought was, even if it has like web and stuff and use that as like a climbing.
Oh, Spider-Man, this shit. You get up to the top of the canopy and you're trying to spot this big tree. Give me a perception check.
Yeah.
This is a massive DC to spot out the Chukara tree in the middle of this forest.
Because
its branches extend for miles. So it's like trying to determine which one is which is hard.
Yeah, and I'll flash a genius it. To add plus 5. Nope.
13. Don't see it, Sigmund. You realize your friends are booking it. You're losing them. You slide down. You keep going.
Yeah.
Sybil and Nova, eventually, after maybe 30 minutes of running, you break. There's just this massive wall of shrubbery. it goes straight through it, not even thinking you break through and you're in this open area. The base of this gargantuan tree, the size of maybe the entire Hanoka Square in New Zatura, this massive four set of skyscraper-like buildings. It's probably the size of that massive base. You can't even see the edges of this base of the tree. As you two break, you see from the roots breaking the ground and breaking the earth, there are about 10 different stumps. Tiny little trees, but the stumps are perfectly cut. There's not a jagged edge. It's like they were perfectly sliced. But all of the roots connect to the base of the tree. What are you two doing?
Sybil, where'd she go? Or where did
she... Anything you're doing, Nova.
Sorry,
The wisp is not
I'm just gonna
here.
Be action dashing, bonus action dashing, if I
no,
see
that's a,
it.
Yeah, the wisp is not there. You come into this clearing, but the wisp is not there.
And it's just got these tree stumps that are cut?
There are 10 tree stumps sticking out from these massive roots underneath. Yep. They're all in like a semicircle.
Can I go sit on one, like crisscross applesauce?
Yeah, you sit on one. What do you do, Nova?
Is right now really the time to be sitting?
I think so.
What's it?
Nova, you sit and you two hear movement barreling towards you fast. Something kicking the dirt up. Until 4 people break through this shrubbery. You see Odavin, Chernika, Talix, and Chernika at the front. Odavin close behind. And maybe a minute later, Sigmund.
Thank you all God you're
six
all alive.
Here.
Wow. You look better. That's good.
Holy
did they actually
shit,
kill you?
This is a tree.
Sigmund, this tree looks very similar, but it's different. Very similar to a tree you saw after eating this fruit in Kurakami Springs.
Yep.
And the other one, there was this purple figure, their arms tied, their hair almost like a slimy wet.
Yep.
Attached to the tree, but the bark was black. This one looks beautiful. There's no one inside it. It's a beautiful tree.
Could I do a nature?
It's pure. Yeah, what are you trying to figure out?
To obtain if it's nature-based or magical in...
You were in the room with the singing blade. She basically told y'all, like, it is the place that this tree connects this world to the spirit world. So, probably fair to say, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Is there any other properties I could try to...
You can give me a nature check.
Can I commune with the spirit tree? Can I cast it while I'm sitting here on this?
Yeah, you absolutely can. 13. It's hard to get anything on a 13. Sybil, you get a challenge from the commune with nature. Playful challenge. Cash me if you can.
Oh, yep. Shit.
Will do. Is there like an indicator somewhere on the tree? Or is it just like a feeling?
It's just from casting the spell is what you get back when you commune with nature.
Gotcha. So this tree is huge and tall.
Massive. Fucking gargantuan. Like, bigger than Ebeneth. Like, it's not even fucking... Ebeneth is like an ant compared to this tree. It's like the Hallig tree in, like, Elden Ring.
Yeah, oh, jeez.
Well, I'm gonna shape change into a monkey and start climbing. Or, I mean, in a wild shape. Into a monkey and start climbing the tree.
You start climbing, you don't see anything, but you see some doves, some other birds, and they kind of flutter away as you get up there.
That's nice up here.
Can I...
Oh, Odavin knows what to do.
What? Odavin knows what to do?
What are you six doing?
I kind of want to just, like, walk around, like, the base of the tree, just kind of, like, you know, hand against it, just trying to, like, just kind of better understand it, I guess. Just,
yeah.
I'm just gonna look for Lo. I don't really know where or where to begin, but looking.
Question. So, with the story that Nova found about Lo, the spirit runner, the story went that the guy who came to wish his son back to life, it was like after he had given up hope and started to turn around that the spirit runner showed, like, appeared to him, right?
That's how the fairy tale goes, yeah.
And then it continued on to the second step of, oh, now you have to catch me.
Mm-hmm. Wait, so okay. If you guys are cured, though, why are we chasing after it?
To cure everyone else.
Yeah, we don't know. Oh. We don't know if killing her will stop everything, so we're just being double safe.
Okay. Double safe.
Didn't the lady... Well, I wasn't there, so I can't ask this question, so... Never
mind. Hey, Juice, what are you thinking? That's it.
out of game. Hey, Volt, didn't the lady give you some instructions on how to get Lone to, like, let you into the spirit tree to actually run the gauntlet?
She
or is it just like we get here and
said
that's it?
If you find the grove, you're worthy.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
We've made prerequisite. Okay, yeah, Sybil's just looking around the tree.
Lo says we're cleared to try. That's where we're at so far.
What are you guys doing?
I'm looking. I'm searching.
No will-o-wisps. You look for about... Go one more time.
I'm sorry. Is Sybil still sitting on one of those stumps?
No, I'm to a monkey and dipped.
Ah.
Yeah, I'm in the tree looking around.
You don't see the will-o-wisp.
Can I try to summon four? Somehow?
Summon what?
Try to call it. Like, hello?
What do you do?
Hello?
Give me a persuasion check.
Okay.
Let's go, Talix. This is your moment.
I don't think so. Did I roll?
28.
28.
Oh, okay.
You see the bark of the tree. You hear it softly begin to fold. Two lines, and then one curved line underneath it.
It drew a smiley face.
Into a little smiley face, and then the bark covers again.
Like something
you
like
are
scratched in it?
It's like perfectly beautiful. Like the bark just folds off. Wow. Like you're peeling the plastic from cheese. It just perfectly folds down, and then it folds back up.
We want to play a game with you. Do you want to play?
There's nothing else other than that sign.
I'm smiling at the smiley sign as well.
Talix smiling at nothing.
I have a question. We never got like a rock solid, this is what Lo looks like. It's always been like a thing that looks like this. Or like a one person, like there's like six different like this is what it looks like.
Rabbit cat thing, yeah.
I'll look around. There's no animals that seem like they're acting weird.
There are a lot of animals here, but they're just enjoying. It's like an animal sanctuary, basically. Like there's birds fucking everywhere. The tiny squirrel comes up. The fox comes around. Like they're everywhere here.
Where's Chloris?
Honestly, I'm gonna walk up to the tree.
Mighty God!
Mighty God! Over there, way over there.
Yeah.
I'm gonna just walk into the tree. It's like puts a hand on the bark. I found you, right? You're Chukar. Chukar is you, Lo.
This is a solid stone fucking like structure, but it feels soft. It almost feels like your hand can mold through it. And as it does, the bark doesn't break. Your hand just melds into the wood.
Oh, David, his mind's like, I want to recently, and I just walked through.
Oh, shit.
David, you walk through the bark. There's no outward movement. It's like you just meld into the bark. Except, it would be. But the other five, you see as Odavin goes to the bark, his body falls back. It's almost like the air catches him and places him down, sitting, his head against the tree.
he's got like a smug look on his face.
Yeah.
But Odavin, you're not here. You're inside the Wishrunner's Grove.
Did he just figure it out?
His body's still there.
You put a hand on there too.
You put your hand over, and similarly, as you try to push forward, there's some resistance, and then you. The just wind catches slow. You and sits you down.
Yeah, I'll go through as well.
Sigma, I'll come the same down thing. And do it too. Fine.
Is anyone not going? Because that is going to change things. Okay, everyone's going.
Yeah.
I want to. Yeah, go ahead.
Did Dasha fall asleep?
No, I'm still here.
Okay.
Wow.
I just haven't heard her at all.
As you enter in. Do you truly deserve a wish? I wonder. Why do you want one?
Sigmund?
Do I deserve a wish? I don't think I do. The sins of my family. And even then, I don't want anything. For myself. Nothing that I don't want to earn. But the people who were hurt by the actions of the Crooked Countess, those who were damned, those who can't even breathe this fresh air without coughing and choking, I don't want that for them. I want them to be able to live and breathe like they always have.
Strange. Strange how that need to save innocence coincides so fortuitously with the need to save yourself, no? You could have made it here much sooner, Sigmund. But you didn't. Nonetheless, catch me if you can.
I'll try and catch.
The grove falls away, as there's only this black and blue hue of a subspace around you. Stars surround, and the grass becomes this pale, silky white sheen of energy and vibrant light. I will pull you to the Wishrunner.
Ooh.
You all can position yourself within these white lines wherever you'd like.
Oh, shit. I think I'm right where I want to be.
Yeah.
I'm going to explain how this will work. Because this shouldn't take too long. Unless y'all royally screw up. But I have faith in y'all. The way this works is, this chase automatically assumes that you are using your movement and your action to dash. That's how chases work. It automatically assumes that your action is used for a dash and you're using all of your movement, okay? If you use any action other than dashing, you fall one space behind, which is 10 feet. So 10 feet equals one space, okay? You each have a chase modifier. For every 5 feet of base movement above 30, you have +3 to your chase check. So if you have 30, you have +3. If you have 35, you have +6. If you have 40, you have +9 to your base movement. And if you have 45, you have +12. Okay? At the start of every round. Yep. So if you have 30, you have 3. If you have 35, you have 6. If you have 40, you have 9. And if you have 45, you have 12. Okay? There's no, it's just a d20 plus that chase. At the start of every round, everyone will roll what I'm calling a chase check. The closer you are to low, the higher the DC. Okay? If you succeed, you gain one space so you can move 10 feet ahead. If you fail the check, you fall 10 feet back, so fall one space. If you fail the check by 5 or more, you fall 20 feet back, 2 spaces. A nat 1 is falling 3 spaces back. A nat 20 is increasing 2 spaces.
Okay.
Once your token is adjacent to Low, you can attempt to grab Low with a DC 21 chase check. All right? Failing puts you back one space. If you fall 7 or more spaces behind Low, you are transported out of the grove. That's what this little white light is. Because Low will not move.
Yeah.
If you're 70 feet from Low, or 75 feet or more than Low, you fail. You are transported out. You can't get back up. This white light, if you're within that white light, I know it's a circle, but if you're within that white light, you're only going to be moving horizontally. Mm-hmm. There's no up or down, so it's just horizontally because you're running. Does that make sense for everybody?
Yes.
Yeah.
Before I add the one.
What about teleportation spells at all?
Spells and ethereal travel don't work in this realm, unfortunately. So misty steps aren't viable. Yep. Dimension doors, things like that are not viable.
Winds.
Yeah.
What does that do?
If
you can make your base movement higher, then what it does is increase your check modifier. Cool. Does that make sense?
So it increases your check modifier. Flying. Does that?
It's running speed. It's specifically walking speed for these rooms because you're running in here. You're running in this realm.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And what about with haste?
That's why it's not based. Haste is great because it essentially doubles your modifier. So if you have you can do the math. So however much you divide that by 5, times that by 3. That's how much you have.
We'll probably use Long Strider for all of us, Masha.
If you, however, no one has any actions up front. You have to cast an action. And if you fall 10 feet back, one space back. All right?
Mm. Is it fair to assume
So keep that in mind. All right? If you have a bonus action dash due to cunning action or anything like that, then you have advantage on your chase checks.
Ooh.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I need everybody to roll initiative for me, please.
Natural 20.
Four.
Whoa.
I'll go last, AJ. Well, actually, maybe not. Because I just want to do something. I'm willingly going to give the chase, but I want to do something before I leave because it's going to knock me back out of this no matter what. Can I just cast Long Strider on everybody else but me?
It's not a concentration, so that works.
Yeah.
That works. Chernika, what'd you get?
Chernika. Sasha, I think she's fallen asleep.
Probably. Odavin, what'd you get?
Sorry, initiative?
Yeah.
Fucking 2 sixes, so 13.
13.
We can probably remove her, because I'm sure she's asleep.
Yeah, I think she fell asleep. It is what it is.
Can we say that she cast Long Strider on us? Or wait,
Sybil is.
I did.
Sybil is.
Okay, never mind.
Cool. Low has initiative of 50, so she doesn't, like, she's always at the top of the round. Let me go ahead.
Yeah, I'm out.
Yes. Yeah. Cool. So at the start of the round, everyone will roll what I'm calling this is a chase check, all right? Or excuse me, on your turn. That's how you gain spaces, all right? So Nova, you are up first. Do you know your modifier, your chase modifier?
I just gave you 10.
With Long Strider, no. So Long Strider gives me.
You don't have Long Strider on it yet. You don't have Long Strider on it yet.
Oh, that's last. Okay, sorry.
Don't
mind. I don't know what my modifier is. I have a 30 walking speed. I'm sorry. Is that 30?
So you have a +3 with advantage.
Okay. With
advantage. On your turn, you're already using your action and movement to stay in the race. Give me a chase check.
Okay.
The first one is not hard to get ahead.
So advantage. +3? Okay.
Yep.
Let's see. Okay,
19? 19 succeeds. You move one space up.
Sweet. Does it matter if I have, like, bonus action dashes and shit?
That's what gives you advantage.
Oh, I see.
Yep,
that's what gives
you advantage.
Okay.
Yep.
That is
it streamlines a chase, these rules. I like them because, like, I was working on him, and I was like, well, the chase doesn't work with two fucking rogues and Talix that has a 45 movement. They just dust them, you know? So it's like, your modifier is your speed. That works for me. It makes everyone useful. It's not based on a strength or dexterity or con. So even those that don't have that can still do something. Because it's not fun. Yeah, it's not fun to be like, I'm gonna catch him.
Druids and people like me from, like, nipping it by, like, tree striding, I go 500. Exactly, there's no chance in
exactly. Yeah,
well, you need trees for tree stride, yeah. So, you know. Yeah,
yeah, and it all depends on the situation.
I like
for sure,
that, yeah.
For sure. Because, like, if you could teleport, you effectively end the chase. Like, in the material world, like, you effectively end the chase. Like, if I run a chase again, like, through alleys, I'll probably do something. Like, if you dimensional, cool, you can go ahead. But that's your action. You're already slow. You can't action and keep running at 60 feet per round. So they're going to breeze by you when they run past you, you know?
Because you're giving up your speed to do something.
You're giving up your speed to do something. Cool. So that's Nova. Talix, give me a chase check. Do you know your modifier?
Yeah, plus
12. God damn! Oh. Woo! Alex moves up 10. All right. You can still use bonus actions, y'all. Just remember, no teleportation. And for those with cunning action, it's part of the dash. Odavin.
I
want to
use a bonus action on...
Oh, yeah.
Sigmund to give him Bardic Inspiration.
Fuck yeah. All right. Odavin, it's your turn. Give me that check, baby.
I will bonus action a kinetic jaunt on myself. So I add 10 to my base speed, which makes my chase check a plus 9. A 45
plus 9,
feet, right?
Cool. Yep.
20 plus 9. 2, so 11.
11. You do succeed the first one.
Cool. There.
All right, and that's concentration. Yes. Sybil, your turn. What you doing?
Just gonna cast launch on everybody else and fall out of the race.
All right, Sybil
is
gone.
I'm counting on you to catch this spirit. See you later.
Am I even gonna try?
I wish for nothing. She disappears.
Sigmund, okay. It's your turn.
I'm actually gonna.
What is long strategy?
So,
plus 10 feet of movement.
Damn.
Cool.
I'm going to six.
Yeah. So I'm actually going to.
DCs get high.
So I'm gonna haste myself.
Ooh.
That's sick.
That's an action. That's an action.
Yep.
So you're gonna fall back 10 feet. One. You are right on the edge. Yep. 10 feet is one space, which is right on the edge. So you feel this mist that pulls you back to the material plane, creeping on you. You have your speed though. Any bonus actions?
I don't think I can do anything on my bonus action. Because I can't move. I don't think I can do anything.
Okay.
Does he make the chase check or no?
No, because I use my action to cast haste.
No, yep.
No,
you, excuse me, at the start of your turn, you still do.
Wait, so...
So I'm wrong. I'm sorry. These are new rules that I'm still working on.
Yeah, no, you're
Sybil,
good.
You can still be in it if you succeed the chase check. You'll still be in it.
Oh, okay. Let me see. I'll roll. Yeah, I'll
because the thing
go.
Is, you make the check at your base starting. But here's the thing, right? Like, Sybil, I'll allow you to cast Longstrider and dip. If you fail the check, you don't get Longstrider because you're gone. You move into the mist and you're gone. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Yeah.
We're good. I'm still here.
Cool. You're good. Fell back. Sigmund, give me it without haste, so just give me a plus 3 check.
Okay.
Because if you fail it, you can't cast haste without falling into the mist.
In that case, I targeted myself.
Use your Bardic Inspiration. Better use your Bardic Inspiration,
yeah.
Or you're gonna not be able to cast haste.
D8. Alright, D8, yep.
Get an 8.
You can do this, Sigmund, my mate.
Okay, that's 10. Is that a pass?
DC is 8 for the first space away.
Yes!
Sigmund, you use your action. You are back right close to the mist. You got haste. You are good.
All right.
All right.
Ah. Get these bad rolls out now. Get these bad rolls out now.
Did you put you at the end of initiative, or did you want to go back to 7?
I'll go to the end of initiative. Fine with me.
Oh,
cool.
On Lowe's turn. Yes.
When I have 55, doesn't mean I have plus 50 now.
55, that is 25 above 30, which is 25 divided by 5 is 5 times 3 is 15. So yes, you have 15.
Damn. You did that long division and multiplication
shit.
That
wasn't long division, Danny.
I don't know.
Basic algebra, babe. on Lowe's turn, Nova, Odavin, and Talix. Give me a wisdom save from all three of you, please.
Oh, no.
Okay. Oh, yeah, the wisdom gang. Wait, I actually do have a plus 3 to wisdom saves. That's kind of funny. Doesn't matter because I rolled a 5. Oof.
Natalia's gonna be a wisdom save.
He's gonna fuck with us? That's crazy. It's almost like yeah.
Is it, I have advantage on these? Because I have my sword.
Some smart?
Oh no, gang.
Gang! Hell yeah, gang!
Nice. Talix, you hear Ramilia's voice behind you. But you know, you like, fuck that. But don't try to fool me, bitch. It's like, motherfucker, don't try to fool me. You're booking it. Odavin and Nova. And again, this is only in your head. Nova, you hear your sister's voice. Odavin, you hear your father's voice. They're both beckoning you back, and in the split second it takes you to look back, you stumble over your feet, you fall back one space.
We both trip over each other.
Damn. Yeah, one space
is
10 feet.
We're like tripping over each other.
But, top of the round, Nova, give me a chase check, please. You have long strike.
Okay, I do. So 40 feet would be a how much?
Six.
Six, okay, plus six.
Add advantage.
Let's go with my need it because it's
yes, you move up 10. Any bonus actions at all?
Nah.
Cool. 50 feet away. All right. Oh, Talix, give me a chase check. Nat 1. You fall 3 spaces back. Talix. Talix, you're out. You know it's not your daughter, but then you gotta. And she's there, and you stop. Just for a brief moment, a second. The second you stop, your feet, your heels hit this mist, you're like, fuck, as the mist covers you and you're out of there.
Damn.
It's not ones are rough here, but nat 20s get you 20 feet up.
That's crazy.
Odavin, it's your turn.
I mean, I'm just going to make sure my math's not wrong.
Like, no.
So what I'm doing is I'm taking my speed, what I can get my speed to,
no.
Minusing 30 for base.
Right? What's your speed?
So it's 55 right now.
55 minus 30 is 25, right?
It's 55 now.
Come on, play.
Adrenaline isn't concentration. It only lasts a round, and it doubles my movement. So I can get to 110 mm-hmm. feet of movement. For
110 feet. So let me do the math.
That's insane.
So 110 minus 30 is 80, divided by 5 is 16, times 3, right, for every 5 feet?
Wait.
Yeah, I see an error in this rule set. I'm definitely not going to give you a plus 48 to your check.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm just not going to do it. I'll cap it out at a 15.
Cool.
Okay.
I'll cap it out. Is that fair? Because I'm not giving you a plus 48.
No, that's
I don't
fair.
Fail.
I'm not gonna give you a plus 48. I'm gonna cap it out at 15.
Cool.
I'm just gonna amend that rule set.
Listen.
Yeah. Hey, new thing. I didn't get a chance to play test it. So, you know, I'll cap it out at 15.
Just want to say, I do have advantage, guys. So if anyone wants to haste me as well, it'd be fucking great.
Back, so, Dom, give me a plus 15 check with adrenaline.
Cool. 31.
31, you succeed. Stigman, your turn, brother. Give me a chase check. Don't fail.
Yeah.
You are the farthest away, so it's easiest to fail. But...
All right, so I have Long Strider, which adds plus 10, so I have 40. I have Haste.
Mm-hmm.
So what does Haste actually do?
10. You have 10. You have plus 10 to your chase.
Okay.
Plus 10. Let's go, Revel. You got this, buddy. I believe in you.
You got plus 10 to your check, brother.
15.
Ooh, good.
Baby. Hoochie mama.
Any bonus action?
Hoochie mama?
I don't think I have anything.
Okay. Sybil, your turn.
Since Jernica is gone... I guess I'll have cast it on myself, so I could have a plus 6.
Give me a chase check first.
Yeah, I'm just going to
try. Without the plus 6.
Oh, without the plus 6?
Because if you cast it, then you fall behind. You have to get ahead before you can cast and fall behind. Do you see what I'm saying?
Then how does everyone else have Long Strider? Because I'm the one that cast it.
You cast it, you moved ahead on your last turn, cast it, and fell back. That's why you're at where you're at now.
That's why I'm saying I already have it.
Oh, you already have it on yourself. Perfect. Oh, okay. I thought you targeted everyone but you. My bad.
No. You're good. 13.
You good. You succeed.
I'm a wild shape into a horsey. I think I have like a 60 or something like that. I know I'll fall back too, but I'll have a 65.
Is it an action to
Yeah, it's an action shape? Wild shape.
Okay. These druids and their horses. Stop.
Draft horse. God damn it.
It's efficient, okay? It's
first not. Session I joined, I turned into a deer.
Is Lo gonna cast Power Word Kill by any chance?
Hopefully. No, on Lo's turn, yeah, I'm gonna roll a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So a d10. 9. That is Sybil.
Sybil
you feel a hand on your side as this big burly man is running next to you as Krotor, your father, is just booking it. There's a smile on his face. You're going to make me chase you all day. What? Give me a wisdom saving throw, please.
Okay. Let me see if I have the thing where I don't have to use the fucking horse's one, because if I have to use the horse's one, I'm screwed.
I'm pretty sure Druids innately use their elemental stats, right?
It's after a certain point. Oh, I have it's the druid connection thing at level 8. Alright, we're good. So, because I was going to say, I was like, because Sybil's actually pretty good at this. The horse, though? Maybe not.
Draft horses? Not very wise.
Yeah, give me a wisdom save.
22.
22 succeeds. The mist kind of frowns a bit, pouts, and then disappears.
I know Nova, father. Come on.
Let me get that chase check.
Sorry. I was trying to send an art piece. Chase check. Okay, so the advantage plus 6. Oh, I needed that. I needed that. I rolled the other one was a nat 1, so 21.
Go up.
Go. Oh, I love this song.
This is sick.
That's
the perfect moment for this song to come on. This
okay. Odavin, give me a chase check. Give me a chase check, Odavin.
He's busy it jamming goes out.
Back down because adrenaline rush is one turn.
Adrenaline.
Cool.
So plus 45?
No,
yeah.
Plus 15.
Cool. 20.
All right, Sigmund, your turn, then Sybil.
Yeah.
Sigmund, give me a chase check.
Yes,
you're hasted,
sir.
So that's plus 10, I believe.
Yep. Ooh, 23.
You're good. All right. Sybil, your turn. Let me get that chase check. What's your movement?
Plus 70 now, because it's 60 for the horse, and then Launch Rider's 10 more. I think it still happens,
are
right?
Are you sure the horse has 60?
A riding horse does.
Okay, cool. So can you transform to a... Perfect. Yeah. 60. I put you as draft. So 60, 70, so 40 divided by 5. That's what? 8?
15, I think.
So plus
8. 8. Okay. Let's see. Let's go.
Not 15.
Good. No, I'm just running now. No, I'm just chasing. Cool. If I'm going to try, I'm going to try all the way.
On Lo's turn, I need the two... Let me read this. I made these mechanics for Lo. On every round, there's something different that happens. First two rounds are visions. Second round, third round, and fourth round are fun, though. The people in the front on the four on the third round, I need an acrobatics check from you both.
Acrobatics check?
Fuck, thank God.
Just people in front, so Nova and Odavin.
Gotcha.
What are we doing?
Acrobatics.
It's like a acrobatics. Mario Sorry, chase game, and I love it.
This is so great. With advantage or no?
No, this is regular acrobatics.
Okay.
You have advantage on, like, the running. This is something that's going to happen.
20, dirty 20.
Dirty 20. As you two are running Odavin and Nova, the ground underneath you, if you could call it that, there's a hole that cuts in the middle of it. Below you, you see the same mist that's behind you. All underneath. You're able to definitely jump over it in stride. You land with a roll and you keep booking it forward. Nova, give me a chase check.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
This is my playtest for campaign 2.
Natural 20!
That 20 gets you increased 2 spaces.
Guys, this is crazy.
Odavin, your turn. This is my playtest for Camp A2, when I'm gonna have y'all chase people through the streets.
Yeah, honestly.
Yes!
I
love that. Adwina win.
26.
This is quite a fucking image, too, by the way.
Sigmund, your turn.
Yes, sir.
24 succeeds, baby. And Sybil.
What's the check? I'm sorry. Blah, blah.
Just same. Regular chase.
The chase.
Oh, just a chase. I'm not plus 8 to this. The thing is,
the founder keeps breaking. What do you want me to do?
So Nova is.
Someone roll it for me, because it's not
2 spaces away. Someone roll a plus 8 for Sybil, please.
I got you. 19, baby. 27.
Good. All right. Low's turn. I need the 2 in the back. Give me... Yep. This one is a charisma saving throw.
All right. I'm going to flash a genius.
Nice.
17.
Succeeds. Sybil, charisma saving throw.
Okay. It's charisma saving throw. Mm-hmm. How about a 13?
13? Yeah. Fails by 1, brother.
No!
Any and all effects that are not based to the character are dispelled. You're basically hit with a dispel magic.
No!
So everything. Dude. So your long stride is gone, your wild shape is gone. Anything that's magical affecting you is gone.
Damn.
The game.
Oh, yikes.
He gave me the back of the hand.
But start of the round, Nova, you still have Longstrider up. You are 2 spaces away from low, so the DC's getting higher.
Yeah. Okay, I'm hoping and praying. One's a natural 16, 22.
22 succeeds. Oh. 22 fucking succeeds.
Do I do anything, or do I have to wait until my next turn?
You have to wait till your next turn. You're not adjacent to low. You have to succeed on 1 more to get to low.
Oh, yeah, I see the space between us. Okay.
Yep. I believe it's an odd number, so let me measure. I might move low. Let's see, because I might move low.
An even amount of movement will be on him.
Yeah. So I would have to move him forward 1?
Yeah, forward 1.
Yeah.
I think, yeah. Cool. Odavin, give me a chase check, plus, unless you're adrenaline rush.
Adrenaline, BB, you got 2 more after this. Come on, fucking nat 2. Oh, 17.
17. You are...
I'm 3 away?
You are technically 4, because it's 4 spaces. You're about 35, 40.
Okay.
I'm going to meet in the middle. How mean do I... Sigma, do you have a flash of genius on you, brother?
I do.
If you use it, 1 will get him there. Because I'm meeting in the middle at 18.
All right. Yes. I'll flash a genius him. So that's my 3rd one.
My boy.
I have 2 left.
Speaking of, Sigma, your turn.
Yep.
Plus 10.
This is crazy.
Sixteen.
Makes it.
Ah.
Close. Oh, it's close. Sybil, your turn.
All right, plus 3. Here we go. I'm still running. Hey, who knows? I might roll a natural 20. We'll see.
Hey!
It's a dirty.
You want me to run
around
to me? That's fine.
Odavin 1, or Nova 1, Odavin 2, Sigmund 3, Sybil 4.
It feels like a hate crime.
4. Still, I'm so sorry.
It does feel like a hate crime.
Sybil, it actually is better that this works. What is your max movement currently? What is your base movement now?
30.
Be so glad this didn't happen to Nova or anyone else with Longstrider. It's half of that. So 15 feet back, we round up. So you move back two spaces. First, give me a charisma save. I'm sorry. Give me a charisma save.
Okay. There's a chance. Oh,
that's crazy.
Nope.
Almost 17.
Back 20. This is
come on, Nova.
Personal, I would say low.
Nova, it is your turn.
So I have to do another check to get to him?
And then on your next turn, if you are still within 5 feet of low, you can make an attempt to grab low.
Okay. No.
14. Fails. The closer you are to low, the harder it is.
Yeah. No, I get that.
Odavin, your turn.
Adrenaline. Twenty-one.
Yes. Hang on. Yes. All right. Sigmund.
Yes, sir.
Can a bitch
get
some haste?
Let's go, Sigmund. And Sybil.
Gotta get those lungs pumping.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Ooh. Ugh. Even at that distance away, it's not gonna do it. You're muted, by the way.
Good. You don't
want to
hear what I'm saying. I'm sad.
On Lowe's turn, I need Odavin. Odavin, Sigmund, and Nova, give me an athletics check, please.
No!
No!
I got a flash of geniuses.
Yeah.
It's an 11.
Just to get something.
13.
Doesn't matter.
Do we all fail?
You all failed? And then Odavin, I can't have you occupy the same space.
Okay.
No, you all failed. Sorry. Everyone moves back. And then Odavin is one ahead.
Yeah.
You see as the walls, as you're running, these ethereal walls appear and shove you all in this perfect line. It's kind of like this wall preventing the natural gait of your arms. It keeps you very tight, like you're running through a narrow corridor. It's hard to keep your speed. You're trying to push against the wall, and they have some give, but with the failed athletics checks, you're trying to push as you fall back a bit, still moving as the walls push you in, and then they let go.
Yeah.
Nova, okay. It is your turn.
Speed check.
I am speed.
Vibe check. Bonk. That sucks. It's
15. Check. No, girl. No, wait, you're four spaces away. Nah, girl.
Nah. I was doing so good in the beginning. I got so close.
That's how this goes. Like, you get close, yeah. And then something fucks you and comes you back. Odavin, your turn.
My last adrenaline. That's it. So I got this.
Maybe.
Fucking plus 15.
I will say, before you adrenaline, you do have to make a DC 21 chase check to catch low.
Yeah, but if I'm not up there, I can't even make the check.
And that's fair. And it's so, you know, adrenaline does give you 15 to that 21 check.
Yeah.
Do you get lethargic with adrenaline?
No.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm going to use it. Just to get up there. Hope maybe someone can help me while after I get up there.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. 30. I think you may have moved him one too far because now he's 10 feet ahead of me. So if I move 10 feet on my turn, I'd be in his space.
That's right. Yeah, on your next turn, you should be able to attempt to catch low. Yeah.
Come on,
Stigmund, your turn.
Yeah. 25.
Let's go, Sigmund!
Siggy!
Sybil, give me a chase check.
What if I don't make it, though?
Can you help me, maybe? Thoughts to end the
combat? Or me!
You'll still be in if you fail. You just can't fail by five or more.
Listen, I did all long strider. I can only affect base movement speed.
You just can't fail by five or more.
Are you able to give someone, like, a distant help action?
You got this!
I guess you could because of hurt, I think, but...
I think the closest, the only person you could is Nova.
Yeah, I've already got advantage.
And she already got advantage.
Yeah. Super advantage,
If you make the chase check, you could get Sigmund. Give him advantage.
Let's see if that'd be nice.
First, and then we'll see what happens. Alright, we need the chase check, I'm pretty sure.
Yes.
Alright, so yeah, and then I'll just use my action to summon Gert next to Sigmund, and he just pushes him.
So is it an action?
Yeah, I think so. Because I'm going to fall back for it. That's okay.
Okay, cool. Just making sure.
Yeah. Because it's an action to summon him.
For sure. Sybil, as you're running, explain to us as Gert helps Sigmund out.
So I'm like, there's no way. I'm not built for this. Gert, I need you to help that one. Just got his lungs behind him. Give him a push. And he just like turns into a little puff cloud with hands and just...
Like Gert launches from the tattoo, now covering half of your arm. As Sigmund, you feel something on your back. The head rears around. It's...
Oh my god. I love that.
I need Sybil to give me a charisma saving throw. No, this one is wisdom. Sorry, this is a wisdom saving throw. Okay. I'm so sorry, this is a wisdom saving throw. It's either charisma or wisdom for her stat block, because it's a weird stat block. It's just a paper... Like a document with a bunch of different fucking things. Sigmund, or Sybil, you see that the mist begins to move forward, but you're able to kind of go against the force of low and keep that back.
Oh, I see.
Nova, give me a check.
Okay. Let's go. Fuck.
Cheater.
Fuck me. Fuck me.
Nova, no. Nova.
You don't fail it by five or more, but you do go back 10 feet, Nova.
At least that's good.
Come on, Odavin.
Odavin, I need a chase check DC 21.
Yeah, so 35.
What's your base speed?
5. So it's still plus 15, right? Because 55 is my speed.
55.
Now.
Yeah.
55? No. So 55 is your speed. Yeah, 15. You have 55 base movement. What is your base movement speed?
Well, it's plus 10 for long strider, and then I did...
So 40.
I did the kinetic jaunt, and it lasts for a minute.
For how long? How much is kinetic jaunt?
10 feet additional.
10, so 50, not 55.
I have 35 base, because I'm an elf. What else?
You have 35 base. Okay, perfect. Yeah, 55, so 15.
So I didn't even outcast it. Dog's fucking accelerated for no reason.
For no reason.
Yeah, well. Hey, man. New rules.
Not my fault you couldn't do many new rules, man.
30.
30. Odav, explain us how you catch the Wish Runner.
I'm fucking booking. I see Nova fucking like trip on a shoelace like twice. I'm like,
God damn you!
I got like a hand out for low and I'm like, it's like here and I'm like about to grab it. I look back at Sigmund like for the yes or no.
I'm like, I trust you.
Fucking.
You try to reach out while running and you realize you're going to have to make a chance for it. You jump forward, just putting everything. If I miss, I miss. You grab low as you roll. And the second your body, almost like a football, catches low, all of you slowly wake up at the base of the Chukara tree. Talix, there's a small little dove on your forehead that's just nesting there. Animals surrounding all of you.
I like the idea of
daytime now.
We're making a nest in Telix's hair.
It's daytime now. There's no will-o-wisp. It's almost dawn. And you can feel the sun, the god rays breaking through the canopy. You all wake up, you get stock of yourselves. And then from the tree, this little will-o-wisp extends out. and is just in front of you, Odavin. Your hands instinctively, as this tiny little basketball will-o-wisp is just there. Good job. Guess you caught me.
You are
okay. Nice. Oh, thanks. So are you. What do you wish for?
Kind of looks around at everyone.
It's your wish.
I wish...
Well, hang on. You are part of a select few that have completed this trial. If it's in my power, I'll fulfill it the best way I know how. Be intentional with the choosing of your words, for while I can see your intent and your heart, it means nothing if the words from your mouth cannot articulate what you may deem to be a worthy wish.
How long do I have to think?
I have places to go. Not really, but...
I understand.
Can we do like a little sidebar with everyone?
Will-o-wisp just leaves from the hands, like floating above your hands, and sits by the tree, just floating. The animals are looking at it. It's whipping around the animals.
What do we want to wear then?
I have an idea. I've been thinking about it for a couple days now, actually. But I don't know if it's within its power.
What is it?
Do you think Lo has the power to cure Spirit Run? There are ways, they said, ancient ways, but that might not mean if, just his whim.
Maybe
if
we
Lo
should...
was the one who...
Go ahead.
Who cursed my ancestor with the spirit rod, and it makes the logical sense that she can remove that curse as well.
I think you're right.
I think so. Whatever it is, I trust that you know how to word it.
This is kind of weird. I mean, I know what I'm going to do, but all those stories we read of people making wishes, I feel it. I feel the weight to wish for what I really want. It's a weird thing.
I can understand. Right now, we've got our greatest wishes within our grasp, so nerve-wracking.
Odavin, you are a good man, an honorable man. Probably the best of us. I trust you.
Yeah, my father raised me right. I know what to do.
I have faith in you.
Me too.
I spent the last few days making sure I had a wish ready, because you never know when you're going to have yourself presented with the opportunity to make a wish, and you don't want to waste like 20 minutes of people's time when you try to think of a wish, you know what I mean?
Who wants to wander that?
I'll kind of break from the group and just kind of like put my hand back out.
A will-o-wisp.
I have my answer. I wish for every creature that has ever been born, and for every creature that ever will be born, to be immune to the affliction I know as Spirit Rod. Even if that means becoming the Countess as well.
It is a noble wish, and thus you have passed the true trial here. However, I am not capable of something like that. I can cure those wrongly affected by this curse. However, and it doesn't have a face, but Sigmund, you feel its eyes on you. Those from the lineage of Ilmaro Taxius, that is beyond my power.
I see.
such as those who may in the future be wrongly afflicted.
Can I amend my wish?
By all means.
I wish for all of those who have been affected by spirit rot wrongly. People in the wedding, people that have been stricken down by someone with the affliction and lived the rest of their days not knowing why they suddenly were dying. I wish for those people to be cured.
Are you sure? What about your father?
We read a lot of stories when we came here. And in pretty much all of them, there's warnings and woes of people that wished for things that they knew they shouldn't wish for. And I thought they were dumb. But I feel it now. Feel the weight. But that father raised me right. That's my wish. I'm sticking by it.
You see the will-o-wisp begins to glow and then expand and expand until it extends into this massive canvas. Just light and mist. As the mist departs, it's very similar to what you would know still as a scrying. But it's people you've never seen. You see this old man in bed, like bed stricken, like looking terrible. He takes out of the bed, throws the covers off, stands up, and he rushes somewhere. It shifts to another old woman. She's carrying pails of water on her back. She's looking haggard. There's a handkerchief over her shoulder that's covered in dried blood. As she's struggling to carry the pails, and then she... she sets the pail down. She beckons someone over. A small little child in the arms of this younger woman kind of arrives. You don't hear the words, you just see the scene. But as she's talking to them, they rejoice in this hug as she picks up the baby, and she seems hesitant at first. And then she holds the baby like she's never been able to hold it before. Oh. It shifts to many scenes like this. There's a child playing on this little dock. There are a couple of kids around them, and they're kind of in the back watching. They have a small little shoal over their head and they're coughing. And then they come on over. The other kids look a bit reserved, hesitant. They're talking about something. And then one of them gives them a rock. And this kid, putting the shoal down, skips the rock and it hits multiple times. Every kid's face lights up there.
Yeah.
And it fades to another person, this time one that you do know. Sigmund, you see your brother. He's hunched over this workbench. But he starts coughing. He holds onto the workbench and then he falls. He's gripping his chest, not like he's having a seizure, but definitely like he's been afflicted with some cough. As he slowly gets up, looks like scared. And then the vision fades in the light. As Lo disappears back into Chukara.
Beautiful wish.
Your brother's got the worst end of it again, it looks like.
Sigmund's just crying for his brother.
I should pull him into a hug. So we'll hug you. Yeah, so we'll come back from...
yeah, let's all do a group hug.
Everyone squish Sigmund a
Davin
little
gives those really, like, rough, like, like those, like,
yeah,
back-punching hugs.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is there anything anyone else wants to do?
I'll just tell Sigmund, just
He's not lost. Just remember that.
Thank you. I know now there is a cure. Even if I may not find it in this land, I can find one. Even if he curses my breath, my name with every breath he takes, he's still family.
That's right.
There's a cure, but more important than that,
everyone else.
There's a root. If we didn't pull up that root, more weeds are gonna sprout.
Deuce is struggling right now.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm not fast enough to catch that fucking thing again. Holy shit, that thing was fast.
Yeah.
You did Jeez. Good.
We're not doing this again, because I don't think no. any of us could. So let's kill that bitch before she makes us do this again.
I second. She needs to die and perish. That's right.
Time to correct the wrongs that my family has made.
Okay.
With that said,
you guys go.
Odavin, do you want my life bane? It's a finesse greatsword.
It's a finesse greatsword?
Mm-hmm.
Two hands nice? Still.
Yeah, but yep. it's huge, right? It's like a big ass sword.
Greatsword.
You can go with a greatsword.
So,
got this.
Like, mechanically, like, he takes it and he's like, how does it work mechanically? Is it light? Is it like, how does it?
You can,
it's just, you can just use your dex. If your strength isn't high enough, you still can't wield it.
Oh, okay. What's the, is there a strength requirement?
For greatswords, I believe it's 13 to wield a greatsword.
Yeah, no.
Could be wrong
he
on
can't,
that.
He can't wield it then.
That's an out of game question.
Yeah.
Cool.
I will.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah. Let me see if I can work with that. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay.
Early group hugged my internet out of existence.
Yeah.
What are you guys doing next? Where are you going?
Like the idea of us all having a group hug and then Talix is suddenly just like, here's my life, man.
Yeah.
Hey, you want a cool sword?
Where do you guys go next?
I will. Because I don't have a spell slot to do it. So let's save spell slots.
Yeah.
I will transport us via plants back to our home.
Cool. As you arrive back in New Zatura, the transport via plants opening here in the Chukara tree. You're stepping through Sigmund. You're one of the last to step through. You get one final vision from the Wish Runner.
Yeah.
You only. There's a woman in bed. You recognize her. You see this drow woman, Guinevere. She's definitely looking haggard. Multiple towels of blood by her bedside. She slowly wakes up. She takes the glass of water by her bed and she takes a sip. It's like surprised that she can actually drink it without heaving. She tries to get herself up and it's kind of like when you're shocked at your own strength, like after you've been sick for like a week and you're like, oh shit, I can move again. She gets up. Just a slight little laugh to herself. As she gets up and she goes deeper into her manor. You all return back to New Zatura. You go back to the burrows under the bridge walk, and as you open the door, you're holding your breath. Please don't let there be nobody. And then there's nobody there. It's just empty townhouse.
I forgot what this feels like.
Guns and swords drawn. Like I'm
just
like at this point, I don't care who you are. You're dying.
Empty townhouse. Dust is kind of settling on some of the furniture. And with a deep sigh. Even though it's like maybe 11, 12, fuck it. You all crawl yourselves up the stairs, opening your doors. The casual understanding as the doors slowly close one after another and bodies hit the feather beds at home. And that's where we're going to end our session tonight, gang.
Yeah!
Let's go!